contact request, and it will be approved. And once it's approved, it'll be easy for you to contact us from that point forward via Skype. So again, Skype username, lrn.fm. Last night, we teased the story, the horrifying story, the update about the baby, the infant in its crib that was severely burned all about its face, from what I understand, by some sort of a, was it a flashbang or a smoke grenade?
Flashbang, yeah.
Flashbang that the police had tossed into its crib. Ostensibly inadvertently tossed into
the crib. I'm certain that it was inadvertent.
But it's certainly not inadvertent when they shoot dogs, and you've got another dog shooting story coming up here in a little bit, Mark. So we've got all kinds of cop-related news, plus in other police-related news, there's a Montana newspaper editor who's been arrested for taking pictures at a traffic accident. He's now facing 2 years in jail for that. And joining you in our studio tonight, it's Ian with you.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
So lots of stuff to talk about tonight, including a bizarre story about Amazon apparently planning to open a brick-and-mortar retail location, which seems counterintuitive to what the whole point of Amazon was. And also, I do definitely want to get to the story about Ross Ulbricht. But since we teased this baby in the crib update story, Mark, do you happen to have that pulled up?
Yeah, I've got it right here. Coming from Habersham County off of WSB-TV. A grand jury recommends no criminal charges in the Habersham County SWAT raid that critically injured a toddler. Bonkam Fonshava, affectionately known as Baby Boo Boo, said was spent
what?
Weeks. Well, that's
was that a name that it was given after the accident happened?
It's a boo boo? I don't know. Yes, it sounds that way. Affectionately known as Baby Boo Boo.
Okay.
I don't know the etymology of the name that people have given to the child. Spent weeks in a burn unit after a SWAT team's flash grenade exploded near his face. The toddler was just 19 months old and asleep in the early morning hours of May the 28th. SWAT officers threw the device into his home while executing a search warrant for a drug suspect. In their 15-page presentment, the grand jury...
How many children's faces must be burned off until finally the war on drugs is won?
And yeah, indeed. It's never going to be one. It's not intended to be one. It is a government make-work program.
I only ask that question for people out there who, the few remaining listeners who might actually support this insanity known as the war on drugs. So how many babies are you willing to have their flesh seared off of their bones?
In their 15-page presentment, the grand jury found no cause for criminal charges against any deputies involved in the botched SWAT raid, but said that they had plenty to say about the investigation. The jury called it sloppy and hurried and not in accordance with Beck's practices. Here's what I want to know.
Okay.
Every single time we hire these police officers, do we not hire them to police themselves?
When did you hire a police officer?
I've never hired a police officer, and I've never had the opportunity, but I think that people believe that police officers are there to protect them, and aren't they first and primarily there to protect them, to protect us from them? Isn't a police officer obligated to say, hey, this is a hurried and sloppy investigation? Excuse me, Sarge, what the hell are you thinking about? Oh, I'm going to pick up a gun and some flash grenades, and I'll be prepared to kick a door in on a house just on the say-so of my superiors. That's not what – I don't think that's what we're thinking of when we, say police. I think it's crazy. Anyway, going on.
I want to just play devil's advocate and be like, you know, what someone who might be thinking is, well, these are real American heroes. They just made a mistake. Cut them some slack.
Well, then I suppose...
Obviously, the grand jury agrees with you, right?
Even though
it was a botched-up investigation, they still cut them slack.
These men are putting their lives on the line every day.
Well, if they were, then they'd be...
For your safety.
Then they'd be in one of the 10 most dangerous jobs in America, and they're not. And if that's so, then we should be thanking fishermen, roofers, truck drivers, and a variety of other people who are in those most dangerous positions. When a truck driver dies, why is there not a parade? Why doesn't the family get a folded flag? It's because we're a bunch of government-worshipping fools. That's why.
How do you define when someone's life is being put on the line? Is it when the life is actually in danger, or is it when there's a chance that their life could be in danger? Because, like you pointed out, right, like getting up on a roof, there's a chance your life is in danger there. What are the chances? Well, probably greater than as a police officer, as far as injury, the possibility for injury or loss of life. But when you go into someone's home for the search of marijuana or cocaine or something like that as your objective, how many of these raids, and we know there's thousands of them, like what, 40,000 a year or something like that?
It's gone up, 50,000, I think.
40 to 50,000 per year of these raids. In how many of those incidents is there actually an officer's life in danger? How many of those incidents do you have someone firing at the police? I bet you it's not very many of them. I bet you it's not even a supermajority of them. I bet you that probably hardly any are actually dangerous to the officers themselves.
Well, Ian, I've seen Breaking Bad, and I know that Walter White was very well armed, so therefore...
Well, all drug dealers.
All drug dealers must be very well armed.
Yeah, I just don't believe that.
And super geniuses.
I don't think that's the case. I don't think the average drug dealer is willing to go down shooting for his or her craft.
I read the news stories. I know about that MS-13 and the
are you still
Latin
playing Devil's
Kings
Advocate here?
And, yes.
Okay.
And the Latin Kings. And whatever those other ones, they're cutting people's heads off at the border, Ian.
Do you see what I'm saying, though? Is it actually, is your life in danger if your life wasn't actually in danger?
Well, I think that that's just the narrative, right?
Right. Like
people, Americans have seen a lot of television, and on that television, the police officers are, you know, their lives are on the line. And I've had police officers tell me, well, you know, if my work was anything like that, I'd better be getting paid better. Mm. Also, the idea of how many tools they have to investigate.
Well,
they really don't
have
that.
These American heroes are keeping those border jumpers at bay. You know, they'd be bringing their diseases and drugs over the border if we didn't have these heroic stormtroopers in black there to stop them from bringing their criminal ways into our beautiful, glorious country so that they can cut off little girls' heads and sell them into sex slavery and then have drugs with everyone.
This is Haversham County, Georgia.
They would be injecting marijuana everywhere.
Are they protecting everybody from South Carolina? I mean, you know, they're nowhere near the border.
They're everywhere.
That's the idea. So I don't know what to say.
So no charges. Case closed.
The grand jury says that the investigation was sloppy and hurried, that it was not in accordance with best practices. The grand jury said that they want law enforcement to pursue drug dealers. The zeal to hold them accountable must not override cautious and patient judgment. So, you know, I don't know what they're trying to say here. It doesn't make any sense. It's like
both sides of their mouth.
Right. It's like, we're not going to hold anybody responsible for the things they do.
But tisk tisk.
But you should be act more responsibly. Yeah.
They're shucking their fingers at them.
You want to know how to make police officers act responsibly? You put some of them on trial. That's exactly what prosecutors do to everybody else. We need to send a message. How many hundreds or thousands of times have you heard it on the news? A prosecutor says, we need to send a message. They don't mind putting your butt or your kid's butt on the line to send a message, but this grand jury doesn't have what it takes to put one police officer. They could have put the chief of police if that's what they wanted to do. You want to send a message? You got a problem with best practices? The commanding officer of this, you could have one officer and charge them with it.
Well, I don't think the chief of police could be responsible for someone throwing a flashbang. I mean, he wasn't the one who tossed the flashbang, right?
Well, there was no drug dealer in the house. They did no investigation on this. It was when they say it's hurried and sloppy, they're right. The reason they did this raid is because they always do raids.
Right. Why bother investigating when you can just kick in someone's door?
No investigation was done. A baby's face got blown off.
Yeah.
Yes, the chief of police could be responsible.
And the child's alive. This I did not know until you told me last night. I don't know what kind of future this child's going to have, but it's certainly not going to be a pleasant one in the dating scene. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here. Share your thoughts. Speaking of prosecutors, we've got their argument in the Silk Road case coming up.
talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Little Jack Horner sat in a corner of his ransacked apartment, wondering what kind of nitwit steals a futon. Luckily, the Geico Insurance Agency had helped him with renter's insurance, and he got full replacement. Unfortunately, little Jack Horner had to have his stomach pumped when he ate a six-month-old Christmas pie. Visit geico.com to see how affordable renter's insurance can be.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here. Bring up anything that you want. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The insane war on drugs continues. We were talking about a baby that had its face burned. Apparently, it lived through this horrifying experience. And now the police officers in that case are not going to be charged. Grand jury looked at it and they said, nope, not going to bring any charges against these guys. So we've got another drug-related story. This one, the Silk Road. You're welcome to comment on any of this or whatever happens to be on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Again, that's 855-450-3733. Now, the Silk Road, it's still in existence. It's this underground drug marketplace, this sort of free market almost. There's some categories that are prohibited, but otherwise you can pretty much sell anything you want on the Silk Road. But drugs are sort of the site's bailiwick, so to speak. And there's, of course, more legal things you can do with Bitcoin. In fact, most of the things you can do with Bitcoin are legal, including collecting a bounty for collecting or for going after a bad guy, for using your investigative skills and busting somebody who's done something wrong. There are bounties available right now at bitcoinbountyhunter.com. In fact, one of them is worth a total of 38 Bitcoin. Bitcoin today, it's up in the last couple of days. What was it, around 350 today or something like that?
350 to 375.
375, yeah. So it's up a little bit. So that's quite a bit of money that you can collect. And those authorities out there, so-called, are not going to be solving these cases. It's going to be done by someone like you who can profit from your work and your skills. So go and check out bitcoinbountyhunter.com. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You know, so the Silk Road, it's this underground marketplace that exists on what's called the dark web. Sounds kind of scary, but it's actually just an anonymizing system. It's called Tor. The Onion Router is what it stands for. You can go to the Tor website and download what's called the Tor Browser Bundle.
Are people still recommending that? I mean, after the Tor crack?
Well, there was news. You're talking about the news that came out a couple months ago,
right? Mm-hmm.
About Tor allegedly not being secure. I don't know who would not recommend it versus who would recommend it. There was some discussion about, well, you know, is Tor still secure after all this information came out? And some people believe that it is. Others don't think that it is. So, I mean, there's no I don't think there's any sort of authority that you can look to say Tor is not secure. But I can tell you this, if you go on the Silk Road right now, you'll find thousands of listings. People are obviously still using Tor under the belief that it is still a secure thing. And the Tor people did say they patched what the issue was with Tor. So if you believe them, or if you have the ability to go and audit the code yourself as a programmer, you can certainly do that.
Right.
So regardless of the status of what people believe about Tor as far as its anonymity protections are concerned, people are still using it. Silk Road 2.0 is going strong. It's this underground marketplace where you can list almost anything and sell it to someone else in the world anonymously. And so the sellers are anonymous on the Silk Road. The buyers are anonymous on the Silk Road. And when you bring in anonymity into drug transactions, that helps protect people from getting raided. Like, if you're doing business on Tor, you are, in my opinion, less likely, if you're a drug dealer or drug customer, you are less likely to have a SWAT team kick in your door, throw a flashbang in your crib, and severely harm, you know, an infant or shoot a dog or possibly kill you. I think it's far less likely.
I would agree with that, but the problem here appears to have been bad investigations. There are 50,000 raids in the United States per year. And that means that police departments across this country are churning out raids hand over fist. That means they don't have the time to investigate. They, the consequences of a botched raid generally aren't bad. We just get a few stories here and there. This is the first time in 10 years we've been doing this show that we've had a baby's face burned off.
I guess if you don't consider the fear and sort of the PTSD of having armed men kick in your... If you're talking about not bad, as in not everyone gets killed during armed raids, I think it can still be pretty bad and pretty traumatizing to have a bunch of strangers gunpoint.
This is among the biggest news stories for a raid in the time we've done this show.
What, the baby story?
Yes. Do you know why, Ian?
Because it's a baby?
That's exactly right.
Okay.
So when an innocent child has its face blown off by some lackadaisical group of cops because they didn't do their job in the first place, and then they get off of it, it's a big deal. And it should be used as a lever to point out that, hey, you know, the drug wars is a mess. Lots of people have damage on the inside.
Yeah, as big a deal if an adult gets shot, too, in a raid. It's a human that's being shot and killed by the police. There's plenty of people that have been killed in these raids. This baby lived through it. Anyway, I'm not trying to minimize what happened to the infant, but to make it sound like, oh, well, the other raids aren't as bad. I think they're also pretty bad as well. So you're welcome to comment on that story. And maybe the grand jury in this case, and I don't, do you recall what the town was in, was it Georgia, you said?
Yeah.
South Carolina? Was it, do you recall what the town was?
Does it Habersham mention? County.
Habersham County.
It was done by the sheriff.
So may not have been a populated area. I don't know. I'm just, you know, throwing that out there as a possibility. Maybe.
Probably not a city.
Yeah, maybe the grand jurors were afraid the cops are going to come after them.
I suppose.
Yeah, that's a very realistic possibility. I mean, if you know, if you live in, you know, Podunk, Georgia, and there's stories going around about how the cops are, because if the cops are bad where you live, this isn't the only incident.
Yeah.
This is just the incident that we've heard about. If
it's a legit critique. I think you're probably, I mean, I don't know what these people thought, but what my general experience is that juries are full of a bunch of
cowards.
Boot-looking cowards.
Yeah.
They're really terrible choices that this nation at one point really did believe the maxim that they'd rather have 10 guilty people go free than have one innocent person put in convicted. Like, they really believed that. They were suspect of their government. But that really changed. And I think it changed with government school, would be my guess. When you send your kid to a government school for 13 years, the chances are they're going to come out believing the government's good. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's an organization. Of course there's going to be propaganda in the government school. What else would there be?
I mean, where we come from, Mark, you and I, and Johnson, you lived there for a while in the Sarasota, mm-hmm. Bradenton, Florida area. The sheriff, and I don't know if he still is the sheriff, but the sheriff in Manatee County was widely known among the underground as—
suspected, as, claimed—
As a drug dealer. I mean, there were plenty of people who claimed that this guy was the top drug dealer in all of Manatee County. He's the kind of guy you don't want to mess with. You know, you don't want to. If you were on the grand jury, you probably wouldn't want to indict him either.
We've seen plenty of sheriffs and police chiefs of police get caught for things.
Sure.
Absolutely. My favorite is the one that was incarcerated in the jail that was named after him.
That's the guy, the guy in Arapahoe County, right? The guy who was busted with a male prostitute,
yeah.
And methamphetamine.
I think that was the one.
He was selling meth.
Yep.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Sheriff.
I think it's when it comes to a specific charge, I don't know the answer as to whether or not, the Manatee County Sheriff at the time, I don't even know if he still is. I have no clue.
I believe the stories.
You believe them because you choose to.
I've heard them from enough people.
Yeah. But it's
enough people with credibility.
Argumentum ad populum.
Mm-hmm.
So you choose to believe it.
No, it's argumentum ad credibilium.
Okay.
Because people have told me I believe them.
I have no clue, but I am willing to say that there are, in counties across America, sheriffs that use their position to control the drug market, to make themselves the biggest drug dealer in the area. It's obvious.
All right, we'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts. Also, the latest federal government has responded. Their prosecutors have responded to the latest motion to dismiss in the Ross Ulbricht Silk Road case as that heads to trial in about a month. More coming up.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Saying that he has no idea what to make of the mixed signals, area man Pete Summers told reporters today he keeps getting ambiguous text messages from local woman Haley Mueller, claiming that she's not at all interested in him.
One minute she's like, I don't want to go out with you. And then she'll mention how she has to go hang out with her boyfriend. I mean, what am I supposed to do with that?
Summers, who first met Mueller at a friend's party last month, informed reporters that the 27-year-old's increasingly perplexing text messages have left him unable to ascertain whether or not she would want to date him. He also noted that Mueller's behavior at social gatherings was equally vague.
Last weekend, we were at a party, and every time I would go up to her, she just said, "Leave me alone." Then I texted her the next day, and She totally doesn't even respond. I mean, she just needs to make up her mind and tell me what she wants. She hasn't answered my last three phone calls, so maybe I should go over there and make sure everything's okay.
This is the Onion News Network.
Should you be able to earn an honest living free from senseless government interference? The Institute for Justice thinks so. That's why we've spent years defending hardworking men and women from pointless government regulations. Nationwide, IJ has created opportunity by reducing government power. But there is still more work to be done. Visit our website today at ij.org. Let IJ take care of the government so you can take care of your business.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free, our number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. You can join us via Skype at username lrn.fm. You need gold or silver? These are great alternative currencies that have been around for a long time, and they are reliable. They're a reliable way to protect yourself against the inflation of the government currency. And so whereas something like Bitcoin, it's new, it's a little uncertain, you don't really know what's going to happen with Bitcoin, gold and silver, there's, oh, I don't know, a couple thousand years of history with those things. So go and get yours at gold.freetalklive.com or silver.freetalklive.com. Both takes you to the same place, which is to Midas Resources, which is sort of one of our business partners. They are actually the company that's behind Genesis Communications Network, which is our syndicate, and they help us get on a bunch of radio stations. We're on over 160 stations, and a lot of it is thanks to the fact that people buy gold and silver from Midas Resources. So if you want to help support Free Talk Live and get gold and silver at the same time, that's the best way to do it. And plus, Midas has also been around for a long time, so they know what they're doing with this whole gold and silver thing. There's all kinds
I've been buying from them for years, and they do great business.
There's all kinds of neat choices, very beautiful coins and pieces there.
They have the Valcombi bar. I don't know if you know what this is, but it's a...
Too fancy for me, but some people are into it.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's kind of neat. So it's a 51-gram pieces put together on a plate, and like it's scored. So if you wanted to break off a gram of gold and use it for currency or whatever, the Valcombi bar allows you to do that.
You could do that, but I prefer to buy just the fancy 0.999 fine silver and gold just because it looks pretty.
I like the I like that too, and they have they have all that.
Gold.freetalklive.com. All
right. How much is a gram of gold worth right now anyway, if you were able to break off a piece of the
Well, that's just
bar.
It. The combi bar, you know, is priced up because it's a special unit. If you're talking about what the spot price is, that's going to be different from what you'd actually pay for a gram of gold.
Right. I mean, it's about, you know, if a 50...
Is it 16 grams in an ounce? Or how many? No, I probably have that wrong. How many grams are in an ounce?
How many grams are in an ounce? Over 400. It's like 460 something.
That's right. Ask Ian. He's going to know all about those that conversion.
Speaking of grams, we're talking.
The one thing he knows about is how to convert small amounts of imperial to metric weights.
Actually, did you know that drug grams are different from drug ounces and grams are different from the actual ounces and grams? Like they say in the drug world, there's 28 grams in an ounce, but that's not actually true. I think it's something like 32 or something like that.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. You'll have to pull up.
So how many regular grams are in an ounce?
I really don't know. Somewhere close to 28. Anyway, you
28,
find
28, you said? I thought you said 400 something.
No, oh, in an ounce?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were asking about a pound. No, never mind.
Right. How many grams? That's why I thought it was 16 grams.
No, it's 20. It's 28 in an ounce.
28. Yeah, okay.
There you go.
So, I was just
I'm a little rusty.
This.
You'll have to excuse me. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So we're talking about the Silk Road. We just kind of scratched the surface on what the Silk Road was in the last hour. Silk Road 1.0 is gone. And actually, it's been about a year now. It was actually around a year ago that Ross Ulbricht was arrested in a public library while ostensibly or allegedly being logged into the Silk Road website on his computer through the Tor browser, this anonymizing browsing system. And the Silk Road was in an underground drug market, which had been online for 2 years, a solid 2 years. It was very successful. It had gotten all kinds of press. And so inevitably, the FBI was very, very interested in taking it down and sending a message that this online drug sales stuff is going to go nowhere. Well, they took down the Silk Road. They arrested Ross Ulbricht, charged him with being the operator of the website, a.k.a. Dread Pirate Roberts. And then a month later, Silk Road 2.0 was launched. In fact, before that happened, there were another two or three different sites that came into prominence that essentially aped what Silk Road did, what under different operators, and one or two of them turned out to be a scam. The other one's still going, Agora Marketplace. I believe it's still online. But Silk Road came back. It's as good as it's ever been. It's as busy and as popular as it's ever been. And so now they've got these other imitators and competitors out there. So not only is Silk Road 2.0 as popular as the original Silk Road, but the competitors are also popular in doing business. So there's now more business online than ever before, thanks to the federal government's efforts to take down the Silk Road. So despite the fact that they have failed at stopping online drug sales, they, of course, still continue to press forward in their case against Ross Ulbricht. And Andy Greenberg over at Wired Magazine has the latest in the case. With only a month until the scheduled trial of Ross Ulbricht, the alleged creator of the Silk Road drug site, and by the way, I've heard rumors that our very own Michelle Seven may be attending that trial.
Oh, good.
And may be giving us daily updates on what happens there. We'll find out more as it approaches. But Ulbricht's defense lawyers have zeroed in on the argument that the U.S. government illegally hacked the billion-dollar black market website to expose the location of its hidden server. The prosecution's latest rebuttal to that argument takes an unexpected tact. They claim that even if the FBI did hack the Silk Road without a warrant, and prosecutors are careful not to admit that they did, that the intrusion would be a perfectly law-abiding act of criminal investigation. On Monday evening, the prosecutors submitted the latest in a series of combative court filings from the two sides of the Silk Road case that have clashed over Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment right to privacy. The government's new argument responds to an affidavit from an expert witness, tech lawyer Joshua Horowitz, brought in by Ulbricht's defense to poke holes in the FBI story of how it located the Silk Road server. In a letter filed last week, Horowitz called out inconsistencies in the FBI's account of stumbling across the Silk Road's IP address while innocently entering miscellaneous data into its login page. He testified the FBI's actions instead sounded more like common hacker intrusion techniques, and Ulbricht's defense has called for an evidentiary hearing to cross-examine the FBI about the operation. In the government's rebuttal, however, Ulbricht's prosecutors don't directly contest the description of their investigation, but they do criticize Horowitz's testimony in passing as, quote, factually and analytically flawed in a number of respects, unquote. Instead, they obliquely argue that the foreign location of the site's server and its reputation as a criminal haven meant that Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment protections against unreasonable search doesn't apply. So the suggestion is that because the location of the server was not in the United States, even if they did hack into it illegally, it wasn't illegal because it wasn't in the United States.
Well, I think that's nonsense. I would say that I think that they have a better case with the claiming that, look, it's not like we didn't know this was criminal activity going on here. So, you know, that's a different, you know, different ball game. I don't know what the specifics are, and I can't make the constitutional arguments, but it was pretty obvious that Silk Road was a marketplace for drugs.
Quote, even if the FBI had somehow hacked into the Silk Road server in order to identify its IP address, such an investigative measure would not have run afoul of the Fourth Amendment, claims the prosecutors in their memorandum of law. They go on to say that given that the Silk Road server was hosting a blatantly criminal website, it would have been reasonable for the FBI to hack into it in order to search it, and any such hack would simply have constituted a search of foreign property known to contain criminal evidence for which a warrant was not necessary, unquote. The Silk Road server in question, after all, was located not in the United States, but in a data center near Reykjavik, Iceland. And though Ulbricht is an American citizen, the prosecutors argue that the server's location abroad make it fair game for remote intrusion. They say that because the Silk Road server was located outside the United States, the Fourth Amendment would not have required a warrant to search the server, whether for its IP address or otherwise, says their filing. In a footnote, the memo adds another strike against Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment protections. The Silk Road was not only hosted in a foreign data center, but also rented from a third-party web hosting service. And because Ulbricht allegedly violated the company's terms of service by using its computers to deal in narcotics and other contraband, that company was exempted from any obligation to protect his privacy. Finally, prosecutors argue that for the 30-year-old Texan to claim privacy protections for Silk Road server, he would have to declare that it belonged to him, a tricky catch-22. Ulbricht hasn't claimed personal possession of that computer's data, as doing so would almost certainly incriminate him. But because he hasn't, he can't claim that his privacy was violated when it was searched, according to the prosecutor's reasoning.
That doesn't make sense. I mean, you can claim that privacy, you violated somebody's privacy to get this information, whether it's mine or not.
But if it, we'll come back with more. That's their argument. 855-450-FREE will give you the latest in the case. Continues in moments. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website, powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams. Most of you know me as a talk show host, but I'm also an author, actor, single father of four, a fitness writer, avid snowboarder, and I'm also a medical marijuana patient. Like many of the million people who are living with multiple sclerosis, I'm in pain every single day. And sometimes my nerves are so raw that if you brushed up against me in an elevator, I'd scream. I can't sleep at night from the pain, and sometimes the spasms in my legs are so intense they will wake me up throughout the night. I've tried the strongest prescription medications available, and I'm going to tell you, they do not work. In fact, they leave me in a stupor, and most of the time, it's impossible to even live your life. Now, I've tried medical marijuana, and I'm going to tell you something, it works. If you'd like more information about medical marijuana, you can contact the Marijuana Policy Project at MPP.org or call 1-877-JOIN-MPP.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free 855-450-FREE. That is the number brought to you by ProXPN. You can join us online as well. Just go to freetalklive.com. Get interactive on the site. And if you want to support what we're doing here with Free Talk Live, then please become an amplifier. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. It's $5 a month, and it makes a huge difference for us when you do that because it allows Free Talk Live to reach out to people all around the world. We can reach out to radio stations in the United States, Canada, try to get on more stations. We're on over 160 so far, and most of those 160 are on because of the efforts of the Free Talk Live amplifiers like you. So you can join the AMP program at amp.freetalklive.com. It'll also support Google AdWords, which is a way for us to reach out directly to internet listeners or people who don't yet listen, but then hopefully will once they find us through those AdWords. So you can help support that. And you can also help support expanding our satellite coverage around the world as well with free-to-air satellite. I'd like to coat the globe with it. Right now we're in Africa, available in most of Africa, as well as all of North and Central America. And we can do more with your $5 a month over at amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines and the newish AMP-only Facebook group, as well as other perks. So go and get the details and get signed up at amp.freetalklive.com. The latest from the Ross Ulbricht case. He's the man who's been accused of being the operator of the Silk Road, the infamous, the world's most infamous underground black marketplace where you can buy fake IDs and drugs and other things that governments around the world really don't want you to buy. And it hasn't been taken offline. Silk Road 2.0 is going strong. So the fact that they're trying to put Ross Ulbricht in prison for the rest of his life is, of course, doing nothing whatsoever to stop people from selling and buying drugs online. Regardless, they continue to push forward. Ulbricht's attorneys had filed a motion to dismiss initially, which was on sort of a different basis. I forget what that one was all about, but it got denied by the judge. This one has yet to be denied, but the prosecution has just answered it with their opinion. The motion to dismiss in this case basically says that, well, we don't say that Ross actually had this server that the FBI hacked into that was running the Silk Road website. But if he did have the server, then it would have been illegal for you to search it because you would have had to have hacked into it in order to get into it, and so therefore that would have been illegal. So the federal government is essentially saying, the prosecutor's response is that, well, no, it wouldn't have been illegal for us to hack into it because it was in another country. And secondarily, he has not admitted that it was his server, and so therefore there is no privacy protection
for
it.
Well, that's good to know that hacking, that so like any hacking that happens, if you hack into a server in another country, you're completely scot-free.
If you're the federal government.
If you If you're for the federal government,
right? If you did it, it would be illegal. Oh.
I guess that you could call this like sort of espionage, right? Like, this is legit. We have spies do this kind of thing all the time. It's okay if they're not American citizens. So if it is we wouldn't do it if it was an American citizen with a foreign account. Are you saying that Mr. Albrecht that this is his account?
Mm-hmm. You know, like. So do you think that applies to anyone who's in the military if they just want to if they happen to have some computer skills and you want to hack into a foreign government foreign private corporation's computer? Just, it's okay. The United States says so. Feel free to destroy our reputation around the world by our, I mean,
you mean if you're doing it on your own volition in the military versus while taking orders?
Sure.
I would say no. I would say that they would think that this is,
I mean, where does it end? Like,
the only thing they can do.
What's the clarity? It's not illegal, apparently, to hack into a private company if it's not in the United States. How does that make any sense?
The memorandum of law from the prosecutors continues here, saying that because Russ Ulbricht has not submitted any affidavit alleging that he had any possessory interest in the Silk Road server, let alone one that would give him reasonable expectation of privacy, his motion should be denied, reads the prosecutor's filing. Early Tuesday, this according to Wire.com, Judge Catherine Forrest ordered Ulbricht's defense to decide within the day whether it will argue that Ulbricht did have an expectation of privacy for the Silk Road server, as well as all his other seized computers and online accounts. She's given him till the end of the day Wednesday to make that argument. Ulbricht's defense didn't immediately respond to a request for comment. The pretrial motion over which Ulbricht's defense lawyers and prosecution have been sparring for the last two months. That's a tough position. Yeah. Doesn't directly seek to have the central narcotics conspiracy and money laundering charges against Ulbricht dismissed. Instead, his lawyers have sought to prove the evidence gathered by law enforcement is tainted. If the initial pinpointing of Silk Road server was illegal, they argue, then practically all of the evidence from the resulting investigation could be rendered inadmissible. That's called, as I understand it, I'm not a lawyer, that's called the fruit of the poison tree doctrine. The idea being that if the police do something illegal to gather evidence on you, then all of that evidence should not be admissible in court. So that's the thrust of the defense in this case. Early last month, the government responded to that motion with an affidavit from former FBI agent Christopher Tarbell describing how the Silk Road server was first found. As he described it, a misconfiguration of the anonymity software Tor allowed the site's login page to leak its IP address. But technical experts in the security and privacy community immediately expressed deep skepticism of that account, and last week Ulbricht's defense responded with a list of inconsistencies in Tarbell's affidavit, as well as new accusations that the FBI had violated the hacking law, known as the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. Ulbricht's attorneys compared the FBI's actions to those of Andrew Weave Arlenheimer, who was convicted in 2012 of conspiracy to violate the CFAA when he and a friend collected more than 100,000 iPad users' email addresses from an insecure AT&T website. Remember that story?
Yeah.
They were just typing in URLs and were able to just change a number and get a bunch of supposedly private data.
Wow.
Well, the important part for me, when hackers do in that circumstance, is they show everybody that, look, you're not secure.
Right. That's sort of the white hat hacker versus a black hat hacker who is trying to hack for their own advantage. While the prosecution's latest filing doesn't dwell on the facts of Tarbell's story, it does point out that the CFAA hacking law is an exemption or has an exemption for law enforcement. Of course. There are in so many criminal statutes, wiretapping, various different things, the government gives themselves an exemption. They get a pass, so they can do all kinds of things legally that you and I are prohibited from doing. In the defense's Arnheimer example, the government argues that the hacker in question impersonated AT&T users to gain access to non-public information. Never mind that the email address in that case were visible to anyone who typed a specific URL into their browser. The FBI's Tarbell, by contrast, only accessed public data on the Silk Road, says the prosecution. And the Tarbell declaration doesn't describe any such impersonation of Silk Road users to gain access to their information on the server. According to the prosecution, they say that it describes his close examination of traffic data received from the Silk Road website, where he used or when he used a part of it that was fully accessible to the public at large, the login interface. The idea being that he just went on the front page of the website and was able to find their IP address.
Well, it's true, right?
maybe. I don't know. And received error messages that were accessible to any user who entered erroneous login information. Regardless of whether the government calls it hacking or mere warrantless search, However, prosecutors' arguments against Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment protections aren't particularly convincing, says the director of civil liberties at Stanford's Law School, Jennifer Granick. This is the Law School's Center for Internet and Society. In the case of the prosecution's argument that Ulbricht would need to declare his ownership of the Silk Road server to claim a right of privacy on its data, she points out that Ulbricht could also claim a right to privacy as a mere user of the site. She says he doesn't have to own the server. Even if he's just communicating on that server, he already has a reasonable expectation of privacy. And as for the government's argument that any foreign server containing an American's data can be searched without a warrant, the Stanford expert says that the notion remains legally unproven at best. This is not an obvious or open-shut argument at all. Overseas searches that target Americans still have to be reasonable, she says. If the target's a U.S. person and it's a U.S. agent looking for information, she says the Fourth Amendment still applies.
Well, that makes sense, too.
That's just her opinion, though, as another attorney.
Well, I mean, I assume that as an attorney, they have some kind of case law that backs them up. But it's, I mean, I can't believe I'm converted by these these attorneys and their legal arguments over and over again.
You mean
again.
You've been converted a couple times during this discussion?
I guess I have in the legal arguments. I'm only looking at this from a legal standpoint because I already believe that free people should be able to put in their bodies what they want and that the Silk Road is... frankly, it's a step up from the black market.
So whether the judge will take a similar view will become clear soon enough. But as Granite contends, the defense has now shown at least that it deserves an evidentiary hearing. So that evidentiary hearing would be about, you know, the FBI's collection of this evidence, and which is what it has requested, with the opportunity to cross-examine the FBI about its methods. So what we might see happen here is if this judge grants the evidentiary hearing, that's going to postpone the actual trial of Ross Ulbricht until the evidentiary hearing is complete, and then that could lead to who knows what. If the evidentiary hearing is denied, they could do an interlocutory appeal to a higher-level court, which, again, would also put the case on hold.
You know,
all the while, Ross will be sitting in a prison cell.
Right, that's the thing is that this isn't really a pleasant alternative, sitting in the county jail.
He's in a federal detention center, from what I understand, although that can sometimes be a county jail. There's more coming up here in moments.
Often.
You can take control of the airwaves. A Montana newspaper man, an editor, has been arrested for taking pictures at a traffic accident. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellawood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellawood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellawood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance. All with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest to you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,217. Silver is trading around $17.34. And Bitcoin is trading around $353. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gun Works, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. In the news, an estimated crowd of 6,000 to 10,000 people will protest in Ferguson this weekend to mark the two-month anniversary of the death of Michael Brown. Hands Up United, Organization for Black Struggle, Missourians Organizing for Reform and Empowerment are all partnering together for a weekend of marches, panels, and planned civil disobedience. Liberty Beat reporter Derek Brose was assaulted and temporarily arrested while waiting to speak at a Houston City Council meeting on Tuesday. Brose had videotaped a Houston Police Department officer grabbing an activist representing Fluoride Free Houston, but then found himself in a similar situation.
I was accused of flipping off a council member and drug out of the council chambers into the hallway before being shoved around a bit more. Eventually, the officers realized I was not guilty of the victimless crime and decided to release me. I asked the officer for an apology, at which point he handcuffed me and accused me of using offensive, abusive language. Eventually, the commanding officers came out and released me with a citation.
Rose plans to contest the charges while raising awareness to the violations of First Amendment rights. Open source activists, scholars, researchers, and electronic freedom groups will celebrate Open Access Week from October 20th to the 26th by raising awareness about the need for free access to scholarly research. This year marks the 8th annual international event that aims to increase open access to information and research while informing the public about the dangers of costly access to knowledge. The theme for 2014 is Generation Open. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook, facebook.com, The Liberty Beat. Flu season is upon us, and the pressure to get the flu vaccine is high. But do you really need to get the shot to stay free of the flu this fall and winter? For the answer, we turn to Catherine Bleich.
The Liberty Beat caught up with Dr. Matthew Buckley to discuss the practical ways to fight off sickness without a flu shot.
So we know that the gut is approximately 80% of the immune system. If we're going to take care of our immune system, we have to stop polluting it with sugar, genetically modified food, unfiltered water, and processed carbohydrates. I recommend eating a paleolithic diet.
The movement to resist vaccine pressure is growing as people begin to distrust the mainstream medical journals and Western allopathic medicine in general. Many individuals have discovered the power of their own body when it comes to fighting off illness. In addition to dietary changes, Dr. Buckley recommends supplementing with vitamin D.
Studies have shown that vitamin D is at least 3 times more effective than a flu vaccine when the levels are actually balanced out.
Ultimately, no one wants to get the flu. While some believe getting the shot will prevent this from happening, many studies show that building your own immune system may be your body's best defense against illness this flu season.
On Wednesday, the Houston City Council voted unanimously to ban the synthetic drug sometimes known as Kush. A state law was already passed in 2011. However, law enforcement have been unable to slow the spread of the drug because chemists make slight alterations to the chemical structure to avoid prosecution. The new law will fine store owners up to $2,000 per package if they continue to sell the synthetic drugs. This will require more funding for lab testing and undercover officers to enforce the ban. Houston Mayor Anise Parker stated the ban was necessary to stop users from experiencing permanent brain damage. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting.
Following today's press conference in which NASA announced its continuing search for a planet capable of supporting NASA, researcher Dr. Kenneth Heiser sat down with Onion reporters to detail their ongoing mission to find a NASA-habitable planet.
Our objective is to find a planet capable of nurturing not just life, but also a sustained interest in the exploration of the cosmos. Such a planet would need to have water and proximity to light and heat, but also life forms with even the vaguest understanding of the importance of astronomical exploration. Ultimately, this would need to be a planet with organisms that have a genuine interest in expanding the limits of their knowledge.
Heiser added that any planet capable of supporting NASA would need to be able to generate a steady stream of financing to meet the agency's $18 billion annual budget.
The important thing is we just need to be patient. There's a limitless number of planets in the universe, and eventually we'll find one with the resources to support our work. We just have to, right?
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything that you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com. And enjoy our features there. We give them to you. You can also get on the air with us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. I have posted the story about the Silk Road, the latest legal wranglings going on in the case. It's slated to go to trial in early November, but if the defense gets their wish, then they will be getting what's called an evidentiary hearing. And I happen to have a little bit of experience with evidentiary hearings, given that, or at least one, given that the Robin Hood case here in Keene, New Hampshire, had a three-day-long evidentiary hearing.
It's a pretty serious evidentiary hearing, huh?
Which, you know, these things happen prior to the actual trial occurring. And so the defense in the Silk Road case is asking for an evidentiary hearing to determine whether or not the FBI used legal methods to achieve the information that they needed to discern the location of the Silk Road server. What is the Silk Road? Well, it's an underground drug marketplace available on the black web or the dark web through the Tor anonymizing service. And Ross Ulbricht is now facing the rest of his life in prison over this. We did not mention in the last hour, but I do need to mention it now. If you want to support Ross Ulbricht, please go to freeross.org. This is a really important case. I mean, if Ross Ulbricht can actually beat this in some way, shape, or form, it'll be a wonderful protection of online privacy, and there's a lot of other things sort of at stake here. But if you think that the insane war on drugs needs to end, this is probably the most preeminent, prominent drug-related case that this country has seen in my lifetime.
Well, what can we expect? What kind of good news can you expect out of this? I mean, it's hard to imagine.
Not guilty.
Based on what?
Well, if the FBI's evidence is thrown out, then the case should be dismissed.
And what does that do for anybody besides Ross Ulbricht?
Well, it means that the FBI can't just go around hacking people's computers, I guess, in that case, in order to...
Online privacy, I'd say that it has some hope in doing something. It doesn't seem like it's going to have anything to do with the war on drugs.
Well, it's not going to end the war on drugs, but if you think the war on drugs is a terrible thing, this is the most prominent drug-related case out there right now.
It's worth keeping an eye on.
If the FBI can lose against someone that they're calling a kingpin, you know, essentially the digital equivalent of a kingpin, they've charged him with the kingpin statutes in this case. If the FBI can lose this case, which...
They accused him basically of running a digital crack house, right? That's what they were basically saying, is that... That the Silk Road is like a crack house online.
I've never heard it called that exactly. I mean, it's a little cleaner than a crack house. There's not any nasty crack binging addicts around to beat you or rob you for your drugs.
Well, you don't know they're around where they are.
Silk Road's a lot of safer way to purchase drugs for the thousands of users who have done so, and it's also a safer way to sell the drugs as well. So, I think that this is an important case, and if you support seeing this guy set free, please go to freeross.org, and you can throw some Bitcoin behind the case. You can donate. I think they're accepting checks. Also, PayPal is an option there. freeross.org.
I'm just saying, you call them a kingpin, and I think that what I thought that the
that's
argument
what the feds are calling him,
right? But I thought that the argument that they were making about the crime that he committed is that it was like running a, you know, that essentially it's like being the landlord of a drug house. essentially was the comparison that they're supposedly making, is that's the legal argument that they're making, is that it's like someone who
is leasing property too.
That is being knowingly used for drugs.
Well, they're alleging that he did more than that, that he was involved more directly with setting up the people's accounts and things like that, and mediating disputes or whatever.
Apparently an assassination.
They're also alleging that he was involved in hiring assassins to keep people quiet about what they knew about the site.
Right.
I don't know whether that those allegations are true, and
they're disturbing. We'll find out. I mean, I guess over time, right? I'd like to know the evidence.
Yeah. So, you know, we'll keep you in the loop here as this case continues to develop. I think it's pretty important. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and ultimately this, I presume this will go in front of a jury. You know,
I think it would have to.
If this does ultimately make it to trial, and hopefully it won't, hopefully the case will be dismissed before then. In fact, this case could be like the Robin Hood case here in Keene, where people, activists are being sued by the city of Keene for filling people's meters. This city of Keene is claiming it's because we're harassing the parking enforcers. But that case never went to trial either. The Robin Hood case was dismissed after the evidentiary hearing. And the appeal that's going to the Supreme Court next week in New Hampshire is an appeal on the dismissal of the case. So if the Supreme Court overturns the dismissal, then the case goes back to trial. So Robin Hood, even though we spent 3.5 days in court, or 3 days in court, that wasn't the actual trial. That was the evidentiary hearing. So the same thing could happen in Ulbricht's case, where the evidentiary hearing is granted. They go and they spend days in this evidentiary hearing. The court then maybe either dismisses the case. If the court dismisses the case, then the feds will probably appeal the dismissal, and then it'll go up even higher. So, I mean, this could go on for quite a long time. Anyway, there's other court-related news, because if Ulbricht's case makes it to a jury, then I hope that we'll see people with the courage of James Babb standing out in front of the courthouse and handing out fully informed jury association, jury nullification information. Now, gentlemen, would one of you like to describe what jury nullification is?
Sure. Jury nullification is a 1,000-year right that juries have had in English common law, where the common people, and that was the idea, was is that you know, courts would... They didn't want to just leave it up to the rich, important judge to make a decision. They wanted to leave it to the common people, and the common people would decide what was right and what was wrong. So even if something was illegal, they could still be found guilty. Like, essentially the law itself is on trial at the same time. So if you are a juror and you believe that a person has been charged, and they may be guilty of breaking the law, you may think that the law itself is a poor choice, and that, you know, you're gonna, this is the system, this is the way it's set up, that you just find them not guilty because you don't think that the thing they did should be illegal, not that it is illegal.
It's an incredibly powerful right of jurors that they've had for, you know, a long time. The courts want to cover this up, however. The courts are very interested in preventing juries from knowing about their right to nullify a case, to nullify the law. It's essentially, the jury is the fourth and final check and balance on this system. This, you know, we're all taught about checks and balances when we were in government school, and that's what makes our system better than the other systems. We've got checks and balances. Well, they really only tell you about the three branches of government in government school. They don't tell you about the fourth branch of the jury. And the jury is essentially the final round. So if you think about it, the legislature passes a bad law. Well, the cops are supposed to be the executive branch. The executive branch is supposed to be a check on the legislature passing bad laws. But, of course, the police don't do that. The police just enforce pretty much whatever they're told to enforce. There is some discretion. I mean, they do have discretion. They could choose not to. But
And more, there's this like psychological erosion of these checks and balances. It becomes more and more a system of, you know, I'll pat your back if you pat, you know, I'll scratch your back if you scratch mine. And,
oh, yeah.
There's no checks and balances anymore. I mean, for the most part, they've been, you know, basically almost completely destroyed at this point.
Which is why the jury can and should do nullification, but they need to know about nullification before they can actually implement it. And of course, as our experience has shown, that even if the jury knows about nullification, they won't necessarily implement it, because juries in many ways are a bunch of cowards, and they're too afraid to do anything that, you know, is the right thing. But nonetheless, that doesn't mean that someone shouldn't give them the information. So in New Hampshire, we've got a number of activists that regularly are out handing out jury nullification information to people, informing them of their rights. And that's what was going on outside of a courthouse in Philadelphia recently. John Vibes over at thefreethoughtproject.com, which is a great website, by the way. Yeah. Always great.
I don't know much about it, but stories sprung up recently.
Yeah, it's been amazing to watch it, and they've really grown quickly. It's very popular on Facebook. Anyway, jury rights activists in the Philadelphia area recently encountered resistance in front of their local courthouse while attempting to educate their neighbors about jury nullification. Among those activists was James Babb, who is an organizer behind the recent push to install jury nullification billboards in cities throughout the United States. We've had James on the show a number of times in the past. He's a listener and supporter of Free Talk Live. We talked about those billboards, and I've got the video footage of a court thug, court security, coming out and threatening James and the other activist out there. We'll play that for you coming up in moments because he does a great job. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
We invite you to take control here at Free Talk Live. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you on the site. You can get interactive. You can submit content there via our Reddit-based system right there to the front page of the site. Do that, please, over at freetalklive.com. The more content there, the better. You can vote up the stuff you like and vote down what you don't. And ultimately, we can check that before the show and see what you think's interesting. Maybe talk about your suggestions. And so you can go and do that over at freetalklive.com.
Is privacy dead? Not if we have anything to say about it. On November the 7th and 8th, coders, privacy specialists, and idea people of all stripes will join together for Hack the Trackers, a transparency and privacy hackathon brought to you by Ghostery. You can enter online or join them in person in New York City to create tools that make the web a more transparent place or help users manage how much data they share. The hacks will be judged by experts and voted on by an online community. And winners will receive a prize package, including the all-new Blackphone, a secure-by-design smartphone for people who recognize the need for privacy and want a simple, secure place to start. Participation is free, and online registration is open now. Visit hackthetrackers.com for more information. It's hackthetrackers.com.
All right, so the story is coming out of the freethoughtproject.com. It is about lying, threatening, intimidating bureaucrats. In this case, court security agents came up against James Babb and at least one other activist. It's not really clear how many activists are involved in this, but it is pretty much James Babb versus, and the cameraman, versus a threatening court security officer outside of a Philadelphia area courthouse. And so this happened actually about 3 days ago. The video is pretty fresh. Now, I don't know if this guy just didn't know who he was dealing with, because James Babb is someone who knows his rights. James Babb is somebody who knows how to stand up for himself. And that's why I really want to play this video here. The article over at thefreethoughtproject.com is good. It kind of summarizes what happens, but it's also pretty clear from actually playing the audio. So I'm just going to give you the audio feed here from the video that is called Court Bully Fails to Intimidate Juror Rights Activists. You got James Babb and some others handing out jury information flyers in front of the Philly courthouse, and then some thug from inside, the head of security, comes out and basically tells some lies and tries to get them to go somewhere else. Here's the video from their YouTube channel. And I'll be linking to this later on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter.
We ask you to move down to the corner here of Court and Main Street.
Okay, we're going to just be on this public sidewalk.
Okay, you're not going to be here because this is, the county has a policy, and I believe some of you have been communicating with. If you're recording me, sir, without telling me on voice.
We're in public. I'm letting you know we're being recorded.
My voice on that video.
We're in public, sir.
Okay, I'm just letting you know.
Sir, we're in public.
So, please move down to the street, down to the corner. That's where our demonstration area is, where we hand out literature. That's the policy of the county. Okay,
now, this guy sounds like he knows what he's talking about, right? Oh, we've got a...
This says things.
There's a zone down the street. Please move down there. Now, there's certain key words that you should, you know, be listening for in this clip. He starts out by saying he's going to ask them to move down the street. And then later he says, please move down the street. But he's a big guy. This guy is kind of a, you know, hefty bureaucrat. He's got kind of a nasty look on his face, and he's doing his best to throw his weight around. So
well, he has a nice voice. I mean, he's saying it in a pleasant manner at this point.
That is the policy of the county. We confirmed this with the commissioner's office.
No, you did not, because I can bring you in my office right now, and I'll show you the email I received from the
He would love to bring you in the office right now, because every moment you're in the office is a moment you're not handing out the information that you wanted to hand out. Now, they're on a public sidewalk, as James will point out here in just a moment, and it's pretty clear that this is a public sidewalk. And this guy, whether he's telling the truth or not, maybe it is their policy to not allow. We've created a policy where you must go down, or you'll be asked to go down to our designated zone, which is, of course, away from anyone who would actually be entering or leaving the courthouse. This is our policy. Well, so what? Your policy doesn't counter the First Amendment, which, of course, should be the highest level of law in the United States. That should be the basis for which we're, you know, going by. Now, I'm no huge fan of the Constitution, but I do like the idea of freedom of speech, especially on public property. And so I think James Babb here is well within his rights to stand and refuse to move when this man is not quite demanding it, but attempting to seem like he is, right? You know, he's saying please move down. I'm asking you to move down.
And you can move down the street, sir.
Your name again?
Chris Daly. Would you like my card?
Sure. We did confirm the policy, and it's for protesting and for petitioning.
Correct. You're petitioning. Please move to the corner.
No, we're not petitioning.
Please move to the corner.
Do you see a
sir?
Petition in our hands?
Please move to the corner.
Again, please move to the corner.
Lots of that.
Please move to the corner. Now, the average person is going to do what they're told. The average person is not going to question this. The newbie to doing outreach.
It's uncomfortable.
Outreach, yeah, the newbie to doing outreach is going to do what they're told because, well, this guy might call the police. This guy might be the police. And the cameraman, by the way, I don't know who the cameraman is, but credit to him, kudos to him, because the man turns to him in the very beginning and says, you can't be, you don't have permission to record this. Well, he continues to record, and then James Babb pulls out his camera and says, I'm also recording this, which is, of course, to me, the most appropriate response. When one guy, some bureaucrat, tells a guy with a camera to stop recording, the first thing you should do is pull out your own camera if you don't already have it and begin recording at that point, because there's a chance that bureaucrat will grab that other person's camera, and you want to make sure that gets on video.
And have a complete record.
Right, absolutely. Because he could shut it off.
Partial record of, from when the one camera is grabbed, and then you have another, the video is continuing, so the whole record is still complete.
Exactly.
That's why I don't think two people's enough either. Frankly,
correct.
Three is better.
Well, this is activism outside of New Hampshire, Mark, where it's hard to
get their best.
More than a handful of people out for something.
We're not petitioning.
Please move to the corner.
Do you see a
sir?
Petition in our hands?
Please move to the corner. I'm going to ask you two more times.
I'm going to stop saying please.
Twice.
And I'll ask you again.
Yeah, and then he says he's going to call the cops.
Have you removed. Now, I'm going to give you an opportunity. I'm going to give you an opportunity to legally hand out whatever you want on county property when the people are coming and going. That's your choice. You can make either or choice.
Okay.
I don't think you understand what the word please means, sir.
I don't think he understands what the word petition means.
No.
Petition means people signing a list.
Either he doesn't understand or he's just purposefully being obtuse and just making demands. Here he's this is kind of a common thing, right? A bureaucrat will give you a choice. Look, it's your choice. You're either going to stop doing this or you're going to do it down there. Which one's it going to be? As though those are your only options. Oh, well, a bureaucrat has told me that these are my only options, so therefore that must be my only option. Well, no. You also have the third option of ignoring everything that he says and continuing on doing what you're doing right where you're doing it. In point of fact, I don't know if I would care about their policy about no protesting. Why should it be any different? Or petitioning. Why should it be any different for me to protest or petition versus hand out information about jury rights?
Well, I don't even know that that they don't call petition and handing things out, but I think that it's wrong to create a free speech zone. The United States Constitution created a free speech zone, and that is the whole world, or at the very least, the one that's under the part of the Constitution rules.
Yeah, it's also wrong to obey the free speech zone when you're told to go into it. Don't do that stuff. More coming up.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com.
As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait,
you gotta go.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared
of
me! What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want. Toll free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. And if you've got some Bitcoin, you can throw some in the Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. Plus, there's some links on there to help you learn more about Bitcoin. Maybe you're brand new to the idea of this amazing decentralized currency, not issued by any government or any bank. Allows you to send money to anyone anywhere in the world in, about an instant for next to zero cost. Go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com. If you are ready to buy some Bitcoin, maybe for the first time, or maybe you want to buy some more, go check out expresscoin.com.
Yeah, you can get Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Darkcoin, several cryptocurrencies over there at expresscoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, so you don't have to worry about any kind of shady dealings. You can get your cryptocurrencies with a money order, check, wire transfer, or you can make a deposit at a local credit union that has shared branching. This makes it really easy. You go to the credit union, you make a deposit, and within a business day, you have your Bitcoins. I've done a great deal of business with ExpressCoin.com. They are stand-up folks. They're going to take good care of you. You could even do it from your smartphone by downloading the app. at expresscoin.com. People in the U.S. and Canada use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice, all with no fee. It's expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. And I think now's a good time. Personally, I believe now's a good time to buy Bitcoin that's been on a little run up today. And, you know, usually that means it's going to continue to run up for a while.
It's been a little run up for the past couple days.
Yeah, the past few days. Expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL.
Got the video here from James Babb, and was actually just talking with him a moment ago on Facebook. His cameraman is Andrew Rumbold, and I just wanted to give him credit where credit is due. Did a great job of continuing to record this government bureaucrat, this overweight government bureaucrat who comes out and attempts
irrelevant?
Well, no, it's not irrelevant. I mean, it's just typical that bureaucrats will grow large. They tend to sit around and eat all day long. So, you know, I think it's worth mentioning. Anyway, this guy comes out and he tries to intimidate James and the other gentleman out there into stopping or moving their outreach project. They are attempting to inform jurors about their rights, jury nullification, your right as a juror to vote not guilty if you think the law itself is bad. So we're talking about the Ross Ulbricht case. If just one juror in the Ross Ulbricht case votes not guilty, that's a mistrial.
It's true.
And that would mean that the feds would have to then bring him on trial again. Of course, if all 12 jurors vote not guilty, then that will be a not guilty verdict. And that is a great way to tell the government that these laws are bad and that they don't agree with them and that we don't agree with them. So I think that jury outreach is really important. It's something that's done fairly consistently here in the Keene, New Hampshire area. Also now in Manchester, they're doing it as well. And I've actually got James Babb on the line with us here from the Philadelphia area. James, are you there with us?
Yes, great to be with you.
Oh, good. You sound great, by the way. Now, just a point of clarification, James, you are on the same computer as is this video, so we're not quite all the way through it. I don't want to. We don't necessarily have to play the whole thing because basically at the end, the cops come and essentially tell you you're in the right and that you know you should be left alone.
Really? It could have gone either way, you know.
Yeah. So I'm going to play just the rest of the interaction with the security bureaucrat who's coming out trying to intimidate you, saying you should please move down to this designated free speech zone or else he's going to call the police. So while I play that, you will not be hearing anything. So I'm just going to bring you back here in just a moment for further thoughts and questions. So stand by there, James. We do have James with us. Here's the rest of the video real quick.
I'd be happy to discuss this with someone else. As you can see, we're on a public sidewalk.
You can please go into the courthouse and go up to the commissioner's office. That's fine with me. And discuss
We've already
with them
reviewed the policy.
Okay. The policy is you cannot be here.
You cannot petition or
you cannot
protest.
Be here.
No. You're here.
I'm an employee here.
Am I handing out
pamphlets?
Sir, I don't want to argue with you. This is a public
Neither
sidewalk.
Neither do I. Please move down the street. That's all I'm asking you.
I respectfully decline.
Well, I love that answer. I respectfully decline. That's a Dave Ridley answer, which is one of the ones that he uses at the Ridley Report when he's asked to do something. And, you know, this guy, for most people, wouldn't sound like he's asking. But he does keep repeating that he's just asking and saying please.
We'll take care of that.
All right, so he just walks away and acts like he's a real tough guy as he walks away. And so James Babb is with us here. So this guy's saying that, James, that you have to, or not have to, but it's the policy, and he's asking you.
He was saying, please.
Yeah, he's, please go down to this free speech zone.
Please lick my boots.
We don't see in the video, James, what this free speech zone is, where it is. Can you describe a little bit more of where he's trying to send you?
I'm not even really sure where he wanted to send us, but it wasn't where we wanted to be, so right. That's all that
somewhere
really
where the sun doesn't shine.
Well, somewhere where there's not as much traffic. Somewhere where there aren't as many people who will ultimately be going into the courthouse, presumably.
Right. There's only one front entrance to the courthouse, and that's where we needed to be, so that's where we were.
How many times have you been at this particular courthouse doing outreach?
This was my first time.
Uh-huh.
This is a neighboring county to where I live. This was Bucks County. Doylestown, Pennsylvania. Some friends had been attempting regular outreach over there, including, you know, some people you may know like NJ Weedman and some other people had attempted to do this kind of outreach on two occasions and were shooed off by these people.
Hmm.
And that's what got me interested. I said, well, I better go over there and see what the deal is.
Bring in the pros.
Well, you know, I wouldn't say I'm a pro. I mean, I have a lot of experience at it, and I certainly didn't want to be harassed or anything,
sure.
But really I wanted to find out, okay, you know, who's really behind this? I wanted to get names. If they're going to shoo me off, I wanted to, you know, I wanted to just really get names and ask questions about what they were doing. And I just asked enough questions to get them to decide, well, maybe I guess we should look up the law. Okay.
Well, ultimately, it was the police who came, and they essentially, you know, mediated this and ultimately told this guy to leave you alone, from what I saw.
It could have worked out worse. They could have said, you know what, we're just going to give you a citation or take you to jail and let the judge figure it out later.
Yeah, so, absolutely.
You know, I am grateful that he decided not to kidnap us or hurt us just reflexively.
Well, it helps, I think, that you had a video camera there. How many people were out with you? Was it just you and the cameraman? That's all I can see in the video.
Yeah, that's all it was. It was just it was just the two of us. You know, in hindsight, I kind of had wished we had taken a few more people with us, but it was just something that Andrew and I had talked about and, you know, just said we were going to just go do it. So we didn't really, you know, make it an event or try to recruit other people.
Well, I think you did a great job, and you know the ability to stand up for yourself, it's an infectious thing. So I think a lot of people are going to see this video. We're certainly going to link to it on our Facebook, Google Plus, Twitter, and you can take a look at the rest of it. I've only gone halfway through the video here. This is only taking you to the point where the you know, this court security bureaucrat storms off saying he's going to call the police. The rest of the video is James interacting with the police and basically being told, yeah, you're fine, you can do anything. But my question, James, is that if their policy did say that you couldn't hand things out in front of the courthouse, would you have gone to the free speech zone?
Well, you know, I don't know what they would have done at that point, because then we'd go to a whole nother level where, you know, is their policy legal? I'm not looking for legal battles myself.
Yeah.
You know, that's not kind of my thing. You know, that would have, the next level would have been, well, you know, your policy's not valid because this is a established public forum as a street. And that's, I think it's pretty well established.
Absolutely.
Again, I'm not a lawyer and I don't give legal advice, but my experience tells me that I can do that on a public sidewalk, regardless of which particular government, claims to occupy it. The funny thing is that, that sidewalk, I don't think is actually even county property. So their policy won't actually apply if they decide to rewrite it.
The police officer did seem confused about that when he first approaches in the video. He seems to believe that it is the county courthouse property, that public sidewalk, but ultimately you know, goes back on that statement later.
Yeah, I mean, it's I don't know who wants to argue that, but we'd actually checked a deed map, and it sort of looks like, without taking out like a surveying team, it looks like the sidewalk is actually run by the Doylestown Borough and not occupied by the county. So go figure.
James, do you mind hanging on for a little bit? Talk a little bit more about jury outreach and your experience?
My pleasure.
I appreciate your time here. James Babb, he is heading up one of the efforts to put out billboards in different major cities informing people about jury nullification. I also want to get an update on that project as well. It's been a while since we've had him on, at least several months. More coming up here, 855-450-FREE. If you've got a question, dial on in. It's Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
Question: could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer: yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro-EM-1 from Terriganics. Pro-EM-1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body.
A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM-1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM-1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM-1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled TERRAGANIX.com. Or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM-1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE is the number. You can also join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. That's where we have Philadelphia Liberty activist and jury nullification specialist James Babb with us here. He is in the video that I have posted on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter called that I've titled Heroic Philly Activists Stand Up to Court Security, Lies, and Intimidation. Really just kind of showing you how it's done when government bureaucrats come up and basically just, you know, BS you about, hey, you can't be here. We have a policy that says you need to be over there by the garbage cans. You can't be protesting. You can't be petitioning. You can't be whatever out in front of this building. We don't want you here because you might give people ideas. You might give people the idea, specifically in this case, about jury nullification. And James Babb has stuck with us here for an extra segment. I appreciate that, James. Last time we had you on, you were talking about the advertising in D.C. in a subway station nearby a courthouse there. That was advertising jury nullification, this idea that juries have this right to nullify the law by voting not guilty and sending a message to the bureaucrats and letting them know that their laws are terrible and they need to, you know, certain laws need to be opposed and shut down there in the jury. So you've been doing that. Are you still working on that project? What's the latest on it?
Yes, that project began about a year ago, and D.C. was the first leg of that project, and that was wildly successful with multiple billboards up for, I think, maybe a total of about 5 months. Got a lot of media attention, which is much more important than people actually seeing the billboard.
Yes.
when they run a picture of the billboard in the Washington Post and put it on Fox, and that's really where the excitement is, and that's how the return on that investment was so incredible. We have since done a campaign in Phoenix. Phoenix got a lot of alternative media exposure, but did not get the same old stream media. So still a very successful and I think
Where'd
very
you do
rewarding
it in Phoenix?
Project, but didn't have the same. I was hoping to get more traction.
What was your location? Where was the billboard in Phoenix?
There's a light rail station in Phoenix, the closest one to their sort of criminal justice complex.
Okay.
So it's a very visible location, high exposure, but the only people that really saw it were people that are actually taking the train in there. So that was okay. Yeah. We've got more in the works. We've got some people that are really anxious to get one going in Springfield, Massachusetts. So funding is underway for that. But
how does somebody donate to this?
Now.
How
does somebody it's a little bit harder?
How does somebody connect with this project to give some money to it?
Right now, we're doing fundraising through Freedom's Phoenix Funding Center. So go to Freedom's Phoenix, and if you click on the Funding Center link, you should see it in one of the top entries there.
Okay, great. So back to the incident. This wasn't in Philadelphia, the one that we played the video of with the court security bureaucrat coming out and trying to intimidate you into going somewhere else. This was a town nearby in the next county over. There had been some issues with other activists being threatened by court security. And ultimately, I don't know if any video came out of those other incidents, but you had a cameraman come with you and you successfully stood your ground against what appeared to be the head of court security coming out. And I love how at the end of the video, you post all of his contact information for anybody that would like to send him an email to let them know their thoughts of his behavior or give him a phone call.
Or maybe a thank you note, you know, just whatever your feelings are.
Well, he was saying please a lot.
He was saying please. That's true. So
he certainly could have been worse. I've seen him.
Yeah. So you're out there. You stand your ground. This guy goes back in. The cops come out. He calls the police. Cops come out. Ultimately, they talk to this bureaucrat and they come back to you and say you're in the right here. It's okay. But this intimidation tactic is very common for bureaucrats. And in fact, I've even seen bureaucrat janitors try to intimidate people. Just it seems like if you're a bureaucrat, if you just love telling people what to do, it's almost like they get off on it to some extent. That they're really interested in controlling you as much as they possibly can. And again, kudos to you, James, for really standing up to yourself. What do you think people should take away from this experience?
Well, I think people need to understand whatever laws and policies are in place when you're doing something like this. And because they don't know, they're going to try to BS you into something. So if you don't know exactly what your rights are, you've got a better chance of being intimidated.
Yes.
But once you know what they are, it's a lot easier. You're still not safe just because of, you know, what their rules are, because they
break
their rules.
You're never safe. You're never safe. Anytime you come into contact with, especially an armed bureaucrat, there's always the chance that you could leave the scene in handcuffs. I mean, that's always a possibility. So there's always
that's
risk involved.
But so, if you know, you can be a lot more confident and calm, at least if you know what the policies are. I think it's going to give you an advantage. And just don't take what they say at face value.
Because they lie.
They lie for a living.
Yeah, I would say this was a victory, James, but I kind of, over time, I've become more and more disenchanted with juries. It seems like when you educate these folks, I mean, here in New Hampshire, I think we've got three counties that are covered every single time they do jury picking juries.
Or close to it, yeah.
Okay, we're close to this. Covering three counties, and we've had one situation of jury nullification that I can think of off the top of my head, and that wasn't somebody that was reached by jury nullification outreach. It was a free stater who already understood the ideas.
That free stater was on the jury.
She was on the jury.
And she flipped the other 11 jurors.
So certainly it was jury nullification, but
not the traditional method.
I kind of feel like the people that use the term sheeple, right? Like, I don't think you should just go around calling people, sheep lycanthropes. But I often feel like there's almost no point in trying to reach out to these people because they're never going to get it.
Well, and that's certainly a possibility. I think many will never get it, but some might. And to me, that's what gives me hope. I'm not trying. I don't have to convince everyone or 51% of everyone. I just need to get through to one person that may make a huge difference in someone's life. And that difference can be incredible. That difference can mean a man or woman goes home to their family and children instead of to a cage.
Yeah.
So, you know, I do the cost benefit analysis and say, well, you know, my cost is fairly low. But that gain, it would be incredible.
Yeah,
so
the cost
that's what I think about, and that's why I keep doing it.
Good point. The cost here in Keene, New Hampshire, is 1 hour a month. I mean, they have jury selection at most once a month, sometimes not at all in some months. And so to go out for an hour and to hand out the flyers to people, to me, it is well worth it. And we have seen those wins. There was, technically it's not a case out of New Hampshire, but Pete Nademo from copblock.org in their Greenfield, Massachusetts trial, there was one guy on that jury that was reached by the idea of jury nullification, and he flipped the whole jury. So, even if that one person is just the lone holdout, that still can delay somebody's conviction and, you know, force another trial or, you know, possibly make the prosecution reconsider or bringing charges. So yeah, all you do is have to find that one person. And the more we put the ideas of jury nullification out there, the better I think we're going to be in general, just because they'll penetrate. People will talk about them. Oh, you know, I got this flyer at the courthouse today. And maybe it'll spread around to more people than we realize.
It is. I mean, I hear stories all the time. I mean, you know, when you're involved in this, people come to you and be like, oh, I got jury duty. I got jury duty. And this is what happened. And I hear stories like literally jurors saying stuff like, well, you know, he wouldn't have been arrested if he wasn't guilty, you know.
Oh man!
But yet, because I know somebody that's in there, he was able to make a difference in that case and get somebody off the hook of victimless crimes just because he happened to know.
How did this country go from guilty until innocent until proven guilty to he wouldn't have been arrested if he wasn't guilty?
It's just like that baby that's got its face blown off at the beginning that we were talking about. You know, it wouldn't have got its face blown off if it hadn't been in a drug den, right?
They found no drugs.
I mean, why was that baby doing there?
They found no drugs.
Well, I mean, but it doesn't matter. I mean, why was that baby hanging out with shady people?
Well, they must have been
obviously
shady.
That baby was making the wrong decisions with its life.
James, thank you, man. So folks who want to support your efforts can go to freedomsphoenix.com, and there's a fundraising area in there, you said?
Yeah, there's a funding center, and look for it in there.
All right, awesome. Anything else you want to share with our audience tonight?
No, it's always a pleasure to be with you. Keep up the great work.
Yep, look forward to seeing you again. Thanks for the call tonight, and certainly keep up the good work out there. Appreciate it. James Babb from the Philadelphia area, great activist. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and he did that with just one cameraman. He stood up to these bureaucrats, stood up to the threat of arrest for so-called trespass with just one cameraman. So it can be done with small amounts of people. In fact, normally when I'm doing jury outreach, I'm alone. Here in New Hampshire, just because I don't need a bunch of people out there. I mean, it's not a bad thing to have
the foundations laid here.
Right. Well, that's right. In this case, he went to a new courthouse, and so these guys didn't know who he was, and they went out and they tried the same old intimidation tactics they try on everybody else, but they came up against a veteran of the activism world, and the bureaucrats lost this one. 855-450-FREE. Here in Keene, New Hampshire, we're long established doing jury outreach. It's been going on for years. There's more coming up. Hour number 3 is on the way. This is Free Talk Live.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Canaan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.52 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,227 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $367. Antiwar.com reports, less than 24 hours after he was appointed by President Abdi Rabu Mansour Hadi, Yemeni Prime Minister-designate Ahmad Awad bin Mubarak had resigned from the post. The Houthi rebels, which control the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a, had spurned Mubarak's appointment, accusing the U.S. of pushing him as a candidate. Leader Abdul Malik al-Houthi called a national protest to correct the mistake yesterday afternoon. Houthi said, "What Yemen needs now is an independent who can have the responsibility in carrying Yemen through this transitional phase," saying he had previously received assurances Mubarak was not under consideration. Mubarak's resignation came almost immediately after the Houthi speech, suggesting he was unwilling to put himself out as the Hadi government's public figure of opposition to the protest movement and the Houthi fighters backing it. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Associated Press reports same-day registration won't be allowed during early voting in North Carolina, and Election Day ballots cast in the wrong precinct will not be counted this fall after the U.S. Supreme Court on Wednesday blocked a ruling that had set aside parts of a 2013 election law. A majority of the nation's highest court agreed to halt the ruling of the 4th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals. Two justices dissented. The decision means the full law will remain enforced while the state and civil rights groups that challenged the law prepare for trial next summer. The full law was enforced during the May primary as well. Early voting in North Carolina begins October 23rd, and the registration deadline remains this Friday as originally planned. The court's order was unsigned, as it typically is in these situations. Justices Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Sonia Sotomayor dissented, saying they would have left the appellate ruling in place. It is unclear how the other seven justices came down on the matter, other than at least five formed a majority and voted in North Carolina's favor. The majority provided no explanation of its ruling, which also stays a preliminary injunction filed by a federal trial court in Winston-Salem. Three lawsuits challenging several provisions have been filed by the North Carolina State NAACP, League of Women Voters, and U.S. government, among others. Other voting law changes passed last year already were to stay in place for the November 4th ballot. They include reducing early voting to 10 days and preparing voters for a photo identification requirement in 2016. During the 2013 Porcupine Freedom Festival, Davy Barker presented an idea for a renegade psychological experiment. Since then, he has refined his idea and put his plan and research into writing. He explains, "We aim to show the world beyond a shadow of a doubt that power corrupts absolutely and corrupt authority deserves no obedience." Authoritarian Sociopathy is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores. Reuters reports U.S. Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy granted a request from Idaho officials on Wednesday and temporarily blocked the planned start of same-sex marriage in that state after a regional federal appeals court struck down the same-sex marriage ban. After some confusion over whether the court's order also affected the ban in Nevada, which was struck down as part of the same Ninth U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals ruling on Tuesday that invalidated the Idaho ban, Kennedy issued a second order hours later saying the stay applies only to Idaho. On Wednesday evening, the legal fight took another twist when same-sex marriage opponents in Nevada filed their own application with the U.S. Supreme Court, asking Kennedy to block weddings in that state. The first brief order issued by the High Court on Wednesday morning said that Idaho same-sex marriage supporters in the case should file a response to the state's emergency request by 5 p.m. Eastern Time today. The court would then decide whether to issue a more permanent stay. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Big tech news this week as Microsoft has unveiled its new generation Xbox One. Designers say the console's revolutionary new voice command feature makes it easier than ever for the Xbox to control its users. According to Microsoft spokesman Don Matrick, quote, "The Xbox One is programmed with a host of simple voice commands that you will respond to instantly. In addition to phrases like jump, shoot, and insert game disc, users will also understand more complicated instructions like download Call of Duty update or come into the room and turn on Xbox."
The Xbox One tells us what games to play, what music to listen to, what shows to watch.
Watch TV.
And with that simple command, I'm watching live TV.
The new Xbox's high-tech sensors can also detect your expression and tell when you're looking away from the television.
Andy, look back at the TV.
Microsoft says the new Xbox can also command you using your smartphone or tablet. TechBuzz is raving, quote, "It's the immersive obedience experience we've been waiting for."
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. Take control of the airwaves here. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, you never really know what these government bureaucrats are going to do. The armed ones tend to be a little bit more dangerous than the ones that aren't. Court security video we shared with you is a video of court security threatening some activists outside of a Philadelphia area courthouse, not actually in Philly, but the next county over. We shared that in the last hour. That's up on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter. You can go and watch that at your leisure. But it's kind of led to a conversation about, you know, these bureaucrats just lying and threatening and intimidating people because they can get away with it with most people. If, you know, if you're new to the world of activism, if you're new to holding a video camera up to record a scene, then you might not know how to respond when you're told, "Hey, you can't do that here. You need to go over there." And that was kind of what we were discussing in the last hour. And there's a related story here from photographyisnotacrime.com about a journalist who is a 53-year-old man who has decades of experience in journalism. And he was just arrested for the very first time ever for taking pictures at a traffic collision.
And the United States is moving down the Reporters Without Borders press freedom
down chart. As in less free.
Yeah, less free. So that's disturbing. When I was a kid, I was told this is the freest country on earth. Over and over. Those are the kind of things I was told. I'd like to know, in what way is the United States freer than other countries at this point? Because all the charts,
not sure about that.
All the charts I see puts the United States usually out of the top 10.
So, by the way, in the studio tonight with you here on Free Talk Live, it's Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
So I've got the story here, actually a larger, more detailed story from the Daily Interlake, dailyinterlake.com. This is Montana. The editor of the Lake County Leader in Polson was arrested Wednesday afternoon while taking photographs at the scene of a head-on collision on Montana 35. Vince Lovato, age 53, was arrested on charges of obstructing a peace officer. And, of course, their other favorites, disorderly conduct and resisting arrest. That sounds like some misdemeanor charges there. Lovato and his wife, Michelle, a reporter from the Leader, drove to the scene of the accident from Polson after hearing about it on the police scanner. He was taking pictures of one of the vehicles involved in the accident when a Montana Highway Patrol trooper arrested him. Details of the incident remain vague since the case is headed for court, and lawyers on both sides have advised their clients not to speak to the press. At some point during the incident, Trooper Anthony Isbell put handcuffs on Lovato, who's 6'3" and 265 pounds, and tried to put him in the backseat of his patrol car. Because of Lovato's size, he apparently did not fit easily in the patrol car, and a Lake County Sheriff's deputy used his pickup truck to transport the arrested editor to the Lake County Jail.
Wait a second. You can't ride in the back of a pickup truck unless you're being taken to jail, apparently.
He was then eventually booked and released under his own recognizance. The Inner Lake contacted Isbell for comment, but he was told to direct any media questions to John Barnes, the communications director at the Attorney General's office, which oversees the Highway Patrol in Montana. Barnes said he was unable to comment and then directed Inner Lake to call the Lake County Attorney's office, which, of course, they didn't comment either. Criminal case, they say, doesn't usually get sent to the county attorney's office until a not guilty plea has been entered by the defendant in court. And since this case is fairly fresh, apparently that hasn't happened yet. When you get released on your own recognizance, that means you don't go to court right away. At least that's how it works here in New Hampshire. So if you get arrested and then processed and released right away, they set you usually with a court date for your arraignment a month down the road. So this guy hasn't pled guilty or not guilty yet at this point. So he's not talking. Nobody's talking. But we know that a journalist who's had decades of experience has been arrested. And as Photography Is Not a Crime points out here, for anyone still unconvinced that many police officers now view photography as a criminal act, here is the defining picture. Veteran journalist Vince Lovato, doing the same job he's done for 33 years, is dumbfounded as he's treated like a criminal and led to a police car by a young state trooper who probably thinks booking photographers on unfounded charges is just part of the daily routine. Now, of course, Photography Is Not a Crime is no stranger to these stories. The great website, photographyisnotacrime.com, they are constantly posting stories that are very, very similar to this one of photographers and videographers being either threatened, intimidated, or actually arrested and hurt for taking pictures.
Yeah.
It's sick.
The Photography Is Not a Crime website, really, what it did for me was reveal to me what is broken about the United States law enforcement sort of system.
One of the many things, but yes.
Now, what's obvious to me is that taking pictures in a country that has the First Amendment is okay to do, especially if you're not talking about taking pictures of, I don't know, nuclear cooling towers and things like that. But
what's wrong with that?
I'm saying especially, right?
Oh, okay.
I mean, this is an accident. The guy's a reporter. One might assume he has even some credentials on him.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, like, this is an obvious case. This guy couldn't fit the big dude in his car, so he calls his boss, who then takes him in a truck. Is that right?
That's correct.
His boss didn't take the rookie officer, put him in the back of his car, and drive him to jail
right,
like he should have. And this is what it's shown me over and over again, is that police cover the butts of police. That's not law enforcement. That's gang activity. When you say, well, we got to do what the officer says because it's the officer, we got to back up our boys in blue, you're not talking about law enforcement anymore. You're talking about the most successful gang members in a given geographic area. Now, and when Photography Not a Crime, is what that website is about is simply that. It's about picture taking. It's not about people who are accused of, you know, this violent crime or that drug crime. Simply taking pictures or video, and you can see over and over and over again. I mean, it's a close to a dozen stories a day sometimes, where police officers step beyond the bounds of their duties,
mm-hmm.
and that's fine. You're going to have bad apples, right? But the problem with bad apples is they spoil the whole bunch. So then when the police officers step beyond the bounds of their roles of their duties and the other officers cover them, that's how I've come to the conclusion that good officers are rare, because yes, they keep on covering. I mean, this is handled case law. This is case law. It's clear you can videotape in public.
You can, but I guarantee you, I can speculate on how this went because I've seen it a bunch of times. In fact, it happened with our friend James Cleveland, who's one of the activists here in the Keene area, aka Robin Hood. He was arrested on similar charges here in Keene. There was a suicide here in Keene a couple months ago, and James was on the scene. He was trying to get video, and the cops told him, "You need to get back. You got to get back." And, you know, he didn't get back fast enough or something like that. The video has yet to come out because the police confiscated his camera. But he did get this on video. And, you know, they charged him with, I think, obstructing government administration and disorderly conduct. Maybe he got a resisting charge. There's like two or three charges in there. This, you know, the same stuff that this guy got charged with in Montana. So I almost guarantee you, I've seen them do it in Austin, and I've seen common, you know, it's so common. The tactic is cop sees someone taking pictures, doesn't like it, comes up and says, you're going to need to get back. You need to get back beyond that pole over there. Just make an arbitrary distance, pull something out of your butt, and tell the photographer he's too close to the scene. Now, there's no actual, from what I know, no actual statute or whatever that prohibits someone from being a certain distance within a scene of some sort of accident or police investigation. But that doesn't mean that the police can't lock down an area. They have this ability to lock down an area, some sort of a zone, mm-hmm. you know, putting up their police tape and create an area that you can't go into. So I almost guarantee you this cop went up to this guy and said, "You're going to have to get back there." And the dude probably protested. He's probably been at a zillion accidents over his 33 years and has taken pictures constantly at that distance before and was likely upset that this officer would all of a sudden, you know, force him to go 30 feet away. "Hey, I can't get a good picture of the damage in this accident if I'm standing 30 feet away. I need to be up close." Well, the officer, of course, will then not care about that and proceed to arrest you for not doing what he said. Then obstructing government administration, and then disorderly conduct, and then resisting arrest because he couldn't get him in the back of the police car.
And the prosecutor will say, "Well, if we don't take this guy to trial and make sure that everybody understands that you have to obey the police officer every time they speak, Western civilization will crumble."
So we're seeing this happen right here in our very own Keene, New Hampshire. We'll keep you up to date. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Are you familiar with our movies on the U.S. Constitution featuring experts like Ron Paul, Edwin Vieira, G. Edward Griffin, and Pat Buchanan? Movies such as Fiat Empire, Original Intent, Cultural Marxism, Corporate Fascism, and Moulin Labbé. Want to become an associate producer on our seventh feature documentary, Midnight Bride? Simply go to midnightbride.us and donate what you can. midnightbride.us.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to is probably so swamped with applicants that he or she is tough to reach. So call early in the day, before 8 a.m., before the palace guards arrive. You'll need your prospect's direct number, and here's a sneaky way to get it. Suppose the company's main number is 555-5000. You should call 555-5012. When someone says, "Good morning, Pam Johnson," you should innocently say, "Oops, somebody here must have written this down wrong. I was calling for Tom Frederick. What's his direct number?" If the very next thing you hear isn't Pam giving you Tom's number, it may be, good morning, Tom Frederick. For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. We use coins.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We'll allow you to bring up anything that you want. All you have to do is dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And that number is brought to you by ProXPN, 855-450-3733. What is ProXPN? It's a global virtual private network. Private meaning encrypting your data, meaning that your internet service provider, which right now is probably saving all of your surfing history, will stop them from doing that because they will have no clue what you're doing with ProXPN. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can start there for free. Just download their free app for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices. Linux users, setup's a little different for you, but it's pretty easy to get started even with Linux. ProXPN.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to get their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to, and the ability to privately torrent as well as get past regionally blocked websites, you can upgrade with code FTL50. FTL standing for Free Talk Live 50, meaning 50% off their annual account price. That brings the price down to about $5 a month. You do it over at proxpn.com/FTL or pay with Bitcoin and use code FTLBTC and you'll get 62% off the price of the annual account. Those discounts are good for the lifetime of the account that you have. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. Promo codes are FTL50 and FTLBTC and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we continue here, there's, you know, always news. There's always some new story about photographers being threatened and arrested. And if you're an independent photographer, and I don't know what the size of the newspaper is in this case. There's a guy, the editor of the Lake County Leader in Polson, Montana. I'm just guessing based on the fact that Montana has hardly any population that Polson is probably not a very, very large place. If one of you wants to Google it real quick and find out what the population is, I'd appreciate it. But I'm just going to guess the Lake County Leader isn't the biggest of newspapers in all of Montana. But regardless, he's still at least working for a paper. There's a chance that they've got an attorney, you know, they have an attorney who could possibly take this case, or that maybe an attorney would be interested in this.
They might be in some kind of network where they, you know, have the use.
That's possible, yeah. Too. Yeah. So, I mean, and it's also possible that an attorney or the ACLU might be interested in taking the case as well. But man, if you're an independent journalist, somebody who's out there, you got your own blog.
You got a blog, right?
And you got a blog, you got a camera, you're out there doing, you know, journalisty photo things, and some cop comes up and threatens you and then arrests you and charges you with the same nonsense. By the way, the charges this man is facing, according to the story in the Daily Interlake, three charges, they're all misdemeanors. Disorderly conduct carries a maximum sentence of $1,000 fine and a year in jail. Obstructing a peace officer and resisting arrest are each carry a maximum sentence of 6 months in jail and $500 fines. So this guy's looking at 2 years in jail as a result of taking a some pictures of a traffic accident. If this were you and you didn't have, you know, an attorney or connections or whatever, this would be a pretty intimidating, scary experience.
Well, you just take the plea in all likelihood. Polson has 4,600 people.
Yeah, roughly.
Yeah, not a big place. And so, yeah, well, of course,
you'd think the editor of the newspaper would get a little pass here. I'm just wondering if this cop is new or they have some kind of problem with each other.
They're targeting him, maybe.
I mean, this guy has to know just about everybody in town.
Maybe there was a critical article posted about the police recently in the news. We're speculating there on this
particular case. It's wild speculation, but it's hard to know.
So if it's you and you're out there, and yeah, you're right, Mark, most people are going to take the plea deal, but that, of course, just encourages them.
Sure it does.
You can't take the plea deal.
Plea deals themselves are unjust. They only help two classes of people. Government bureaucrats who we pay to do a job, and they're essentially not doing it by offering a plea deal, and guilty people. All the other people, everybody else is harmed by them. Innocent people, and there's a lot of them that end up taking plea deals. I wouldn't say a majority by any stretch, but a lot of them end up taking plea deals. Victims. Everybody's harmed by this.
The best thing you can do, and this is a general statement for victimless crimes, but it certainly is an important thing to do in this case because having a free press is so important. There's a reason why it was put in the U.S. Constitution and the First Amendment. It's so important because if the government goons are able to do their nastiness under the cover of darkness, if no one can bring a camera around when the government goons are doing something that they shouldn't be doing, then they're going to get away with doing more nasty things. And they'll get away with hurting more people. And they'll get away with more corruption. And so it's so important to preserve this. But that, of course, requires you putting something on the line. Because when they charge you with what could be 2 years in jail and $2,000 in fines, the average person, the person who just started up their blog to try to do their own independent journalism,
they're out of business.
They're going to feel like, I can't handle this. I've got a job that, you know, pays me money. I've got a day job I've got to go to. I've got a family to take care of. And they're going to come to him and they're going to say, look, buddy, you're guilty. And we're going to find you guilty in court. Now, look, if you want this to go smoothly, tell you what. We'll drop two of the three charges. We'll drop the obstructing a peace officer and resisting arrest charges, and we'll give you a conviction on the disorderly conduct. We'll make it a violation. We'll drop it from a misdemeanor, so it won't even be a real crime. It's just a violation level, so you'll get a violation level disorderly conduct and let's say a $250 fine. What do you say? Most people are going to say yeah.
Oh yeah, they're going to do it.
They're going to say, yeah,
that's what they did to you when you were in the Palmer, Massachusetts courthouse, video recording, legally, completely legally. We know because the ACLU took your case, took it all the way to trial, and you got a settlement.
Yep, $5,000.
Was it a ruling or a settlement?
It was a settlement.
Okay, great. The judge was plea bargaining with you.
Yes.
And, okay, so A, put her in jail. She's doing the wrong job. She's not acting like a referee. So, she should never work as a judge again. But
she's just doing her job, man. They all do that.
No, it's
stuff.
Not her job. That's the prosecutor's job.
Yep. And the lines have been blurred.
Right. She's trying to get you to plead guilty. That's insane, and the lines have been blurred.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the criminal justice system is, it's a prosecutor in a white robe sitting up on the bench, it's a prosecutor working you, and the guy from the public defender's office has dinner with him.
I'm just wondering what accent it is that Mark picks up when he starts yelling and he says, prosecutor. He said prosecutor when he was speaking, but when he yelled, he's like, prosecutor.
I don't know.
If anyone can identify the accent, feel free to call in. 855-450-FREE. But yeah, people are going to take the deal. They're going to take the offer. And every time you take an offer that is, you know, in a case like this, especially in a case, it's one thing if you do it with an open container violation. You know, that's not going to change ultimately how things operate in society. But if you do it on a freedom of the press issue, you are ceding ground to them. You are telling them that all they have to do to shut you up is just effect an illegal arrest and give you a sweet looking plea deal, because ultimately what they do with these arrests is they get you out of their hair. They don't want you where you are, and then they arrest you in order to remove you from the scene, knowing ultimately that you're probably going to take the plea. They'll get a conviction on your record. It'll all be said and done, and the scene will be over with, and you'll be gone. And they were in the wrong, and they're in the wrong on this one, and they're almost always in the wrong every time they threaten and arrest photographers. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here. You can share your thoughts. If you think photographers should be arrested, we'd love to hear from you.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Free Talk Live.
Most people, when it comes to what the government demands about their property, the zoning board or whatever department we're dealing with here that claims to have dominion over what you believe to be your property, most people just go along to get along because they understand that something nasty will happen if they don't. They understand that if they don't do what the people calling themselves government demand that they do, that eventually men with guns are going to come to their house, possibly just take it from them. And I think everybody inherently knows that there's a threat of violence behind what the government does. Oh, I know. You like to tell yourself stories about how it's the price of civilization to pay taxes. The price of civilization is zoning. It's the price of civilization to obey orders.
Well, don't forget the pig farm excuse.
Oh, sure, yeah.
If you didn't have zoning, somebody would open a pig farm right next door to you.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls toll free. If you dial in, you can bring up anything at 855-450-FREE. And maybe you think these photographers should be being arrested. We can't have these people out taking pictures of traffic accidents. There could be children in those cars, which, of course, is the common excuse that the police will use. For instance, if you pull out a camera in the courthouses in New Hampshire, they will threaten you. That is one place that is an ostensibly public place where they will get very upset and violent if you have a camera without their permission. And I think that's wrong. I think that cameras should be allowed in any government building, regardless of whether it's a courthouse or not. But the classic excuse is, oh, there's juveniles. There could be juveniles in here. You can't have a camera around. As though I can't go. As though if it were my thing to take pictures of kids in court, as though I couldn't go outside of the courthouse and then take pictures of all the kids that come and leave from the courthouse. It's so stupid. It's such a BS excuse.
We've had cases that we've talked about on the air. It's legal to go to a playground and take pictures of kids.
Of course it is.
You're liable to get lynched by the parents because the world's so concerned with stranger danger.
Yeah.
But what if you're trying to put together some kind? What if you're a photographer and you're trying to put together a piece that it requires, I don't know, kids on a merry-go-round or seeing some kids swinging or something like that?
Hey, at coffee.freetalklive.com, you get a free pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. You can go to coffee.freetalklive.com, get yourself hooked up with that first pound for free. You just pay the shipping cost, and you can cancel your subscription at any time. Don't think you're going to want to cancel. If you love good coffee, this is some great coffee. And you can, of course, customize your subscription. Have it sent to you as often as you'd like. Have the amount sent that you prefer. You want to get a pound every 2 weeks, every 4 weeks, whatever. You can do that over at coffee.freetalklive.com. But more important than all that is every time, every 10 Free Talk Live listeners that sign up at coffee.freetalklive.com will be able to fund a micro loan. So we partnered with BuzzBox and Kiva to fund microloans to folks in different parts of the world that are, living in tough parts of the world to live and need a little bit of help taking their business to the next level or maybe starting up a new business. We can help people make that happen by you just buying coffee from coffee.freetalklive.com. So go there, get your free pound, your first pound for free. Coffee.freetalklive.com. We got all the phones here. Tom is listening in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Tom.
Yes, I was listening about your plea bargaining, and you're absolutely right. People need to stand up against them, or they're just going to try to get away with anything that they want. A friend of mine, she went through a roadblock, and she doesn't even drink. And she blew absolutely nothing on the breathalyzer, and they still had to. She didn't have any marijuana or anything, and they wanted her to do a field sobriety test, which she did. But she has back problems, back and hip problems, and she couldn't do them, and so he still wanted her to take a blood test.
God.
And charged her with DUI. She refused the blood test and went to court for arraignment. He thought that she would go ahead and plead guilty, I guess, because...
Yeah, like so many people do.
Almost everyone does.
But... she was going to plead not guilty and request a court-appointed attorney, but he didn't have any evidence or anything, and he didn't even file the paperwork. So they dismissed it, but they said with prejudice.
That's good.
Without prejudice.
Oh, without prejudice? Okay.
And I guess that means if he wanted to rearrest her, which that doesn't even make sense.
No, he's still without evidence, but, this is a big pain in the butt for her. There's no doubt about it.
Tom, thanks for the call tonight, man.
And I live on Social Security disability myself, and I'm out $185 to the bail bondsman for getting her out. She's a young lady, has to...
Great point. You don't get a refund from the bail bondsman.
Yeah, no refund from him, 11 and 12 years old. She had to pay $50 within 10 business days to keep her driver's driving privileges. They were going to be revoked, and she hadn't even been to court yet. If you don't file within 10 days, your license is automatically suspended.
The system's crazy, and they nickel and dime you to death. And Tom, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. I've got a good not pleading story coming up as well from right here in one of our co-hosts, Derek J. Freeman.
It doesn't take a genius to do the math on this. It's far less than 1% of cases, arrests, end up in a courtroom. Not a courtroom, but a trial. Because obviously you can go to court without getting a trial, arraignments and those kind of things. Far less than 1%. Now, that means the rest of them are either pled out or the charges are dropped. And I would say that in most cases, it's pleading out. Why not? They've got nothing to lose. So you're talking about far less than 1%. And of the felonies that make it to trial, 66% of them are found guilty. This must be the most amazingly efficient criminal justice system the world's ever seen, because you're talking about something like 0.1% of people are not guilty. It's insane.
Charlie is with us, listening in Louisville. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian Johnson and Mark. Hello, Charlie.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Trivial question, and you may have touched on it, but I didn't hear. I'm curious about the change in the bumper music.
Yeah, we've changed the bumper music since Saturday. We've been talking with a consultant, and I don't just generally listen to everything consultants say in this business, but we like to hire consultants every now and then, you know, these guys that have been around the radio business forever, just to see what their critiques of the show are, and that way we can sort of, you know, assess those critiques and say, well, you know, that's worth something, or that's just a hill of beans. And so the idea was to take away sort of the melodic music, the recognizable tracks, and replace them with more newsy style, kind of what's called pacing beds, to not be as distracting from the talk content on the show.
I guess all that makes sense, but I kind of had an affinity for the Megadeth, Metallica.
I'm sure you did.
We knew it was coming.
That liked them.
We knew that this is obviously, you know, like, we're like, oh God, we know that this is what it's going to be, because nobody likes change, right?
Yep.
And especially change that wasn't your idea. Everybody likes change that's their idea.
I resisted changing the music beds for a long time, but when this was proposed, the actual proposal was that we eliminate music beds entirely from the show. And just because of the way the network clock is set up and the way the kind of the technical aspects of the show work, we have to have some sort of form of music beds. And so for our listeners that don't know what we're talking about, music beds are radio slang for the music that goes underneath the talking.
We start all and end. Go to sleep with a bed that when we lie on it, it starts playing music.
No, not like that. So obviously people are going to be upset at this, and you know, it is what it is. Maybe, you know, it's not a guarantee that we're going to keep these same beds that we've put in, but it is definitely a change that has been made.
And the concept is that in talk radio, you shouldn't have music, because what it does is it indicates to the listener's brain that, hey, you know, that the ads are coming up, and we want we don't want now you can go away to some other station and listen to something else, because we've given you the signal the ads are coming up. And you don't want to give that signal. So it gives Free Talk Live a competitive edge against other shows that are doing...
in theory.
Yeah, that's the theory.
We don't know if it's true or not.
What are we supposed to do?
It was worth a try.
10,000 people and do a double-blind study? How are we going to find out?
Plus, it can kind of suck having the copyrighted music on the show. Like, for instance, we've got SoundCloud as our host, which is a great host. It's a great host. But if there have been times where we won't talk for 30 seconds because somebody's doing something in the studio and we're distracted and we didn't realize that, you know, the music was playing or something like that, and then when we upload that show to SoundCloud, they red flag it and they say, you violated copyright, and then, you know, it gets to be a hassle sometimes.
So we have to get rid of the copyrighted music.
Yeah, so that's one other thing, but that wasn't the main thrust. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. a barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellawood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellawood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellawood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance, all with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest to you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
The human body is extraordinary. Despite all the stresses we inflict upon it, it still works hard to stay in balance. Thousands upon thousands of people rely upon Heart and Body Extract to help their body stay balanced. This excellent 100% natural herbal formula helps maintain healthy blood pressure levels, cleans arteries, promotes good circulation, balances cholesterol, and more. HB Extract, paired with healthy lifestyle choices like good nutrition and exercise, can give you a life free of pain, sickness, and fear. Recapture your youthful vitality and experience your body healing itself with the aid of HB Extract. It's extremely effective and it starts working in just days. Visit HBExtract.com to learn more and to read scores of testimonials from satisfied customers. And we've never increased our price in over 10 years. That makes Heart and Body Extract as great a value now as it was the first day we sold it. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Call 866-295-5305 or go to HBExtract.com.
Everybody who doesn't like it is allowed.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Better music bed for us. Okay. You can spend hours searching just like I did. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number here tonight. That's 855-450-3733. You know, I can't say for sure that the new music selections on the show will be the ones that are here to stay, but they are the ones that are here now. And if you don't like it, Mark says he's taking submissions on new music suggestions.
Email him to mark@freetalklive.com.
If it's
now, well, can you guys explain what a pacing bed is?
You know, well, what? That's a good question.
I looked it up on Google, and I think that this is, you know, our consultant. He's a big name in the radio business. I think that's his term.
Because immediately I think of the pacing bed is the bed that gets out in front of all the other beds and like sets the pace as they're going around the track.
A bed is, we're talking about a music bed, which is like the intros and the extros, or the music that's played coming into the show and the music played going out of the show, or noise. I don't even know what this is, music. But it's the idea is to make it less obtrusive. The right. whole point is to trade in the bright...
slamming Megadeth.
What other talk radio programs use pacing beds?
I have no idea.
I do know that this consultant has worked with some very popular shows, including Howard Stern, and I don't know what he does as far as music in and out.
We're not trying to do what other talk radio shows do, necessarily.
Well, no, but, I mean, you weren't necessarily doing that when you were using Megadeth.
Sure, so. I was. I mean, there's plenty of talk radio that uses heavy metal. I mean, Michael Savage uses heavy metal. Sure. He plays Metallica on his show the few times I've heard it. So the only reason I played heavy metal in the past was because I used to be a rock and roll disc jockey, and
to have that long hair.
I was never able to play some of these songs on the radio, so this was my way of putting the songs I always wanted to put on the radio, and we played those same songs for over a decade on Free Talk Live.
The one time you tried to play Megadeth on 105.9 WYNF.
Oh, I played it more than once.
But you got caught playing it in the middle of the night.
Yes, I did get caught at like 4 in the morning one time.
I think if we want to be hip with the kids, the bed should be dubstep. Just kidding.
Well, that's just it. I mean, it's not, the idea is to not have beds that are recognizable. Nobody knows, you know, when you hear these beds,
I'm a big Skrillex fan, so I'm there.
You don't know what the composer is of these beds. You have no idea. And so they're not as distracting, because if you're listening to the music, like, you know, when you're making commercials in the radio business, you know, there's different way, you know, different theories around this, right? No, there's not necessarily one right answer here. There's
I don't make
theories.
Commercials with music underneath them because
it could distract.
Well, it doesn't. When you're on talk radio, you don't hear music right now when you're listening to my voice.
Yeah.
That's, you know, that's the authoritative, the entertainment portion of the show has no music underneath it. Why would you put music underneath a commercial that's playing on talk radio? I don't believe in it. However, I thoroughly believe in putting music underneath a commercial that's on music radio.
Well, I think that there's different theories here, right?
Yes, so if there are.
If, for instance, let's say there was a station that had almost no music under the commercials, and I were an advertiser. I might want music under my commercial to be more conspicuous.
Indeed.
In a commercial break that has no music.
I'd support it in that moment in time if you're a local advertiser, especially if you have your own jingle that's specifically made for you. And when people hear those tones, they think, you know, that's Bob's Car Wash.
The motivation for the change on Free Talk Live was not copyright. That was never the motivation, because you know, we've used copyrighted music.
It's an advantage
for a long time. But that's a secondary bonus. Is that when I upload the archives to SoundCloud at night, now that we don't have copyrighted music, there's no chance any of our archives will get flagged and you can't upload this. You know, these automatic systems that'll scan your uploads. That's really annoying when that happens. And so there's that. But that wasn't the primary reasoning. The reasoning that the consultant gave that I thought was solid reasoning is the idea that, you know, music can be distracting from the actual talk content. You don't want someone listening to the music beneath you. And if it's a tune they recognize, they may be more interested in actually, or they're more, you know, not necessarily it's a conscious choice, but that unconsciously they'd be more listening to the music than actually paying attention to what you're saying. And then, of course, there's the other example of, you know, when you're going out into a break, it's preferable to not signal that sort of thing. You know, and back when we did the show as a local show, when Free Talk Live, for the 2 years that it was a local show in Sarasota, Florida, we had control over all the breaks, and we could run the breaks whenever we wanted to. So when you do a nationally syndicated show like we do, your breaks have to be a certain length every time, and they have to be predictable because your affiliate stations have to know what to expect, right? They have to know what's coming to some extent so they can have their commercials that they play, because the way that nationally syndicated radio works most frequently, a show like Rush Limbaugh, this doesn't apply to in a lot of cases, because stations will actually pay Rush Limbaugh to run his show.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen with Free Talk Live. We do what's called a barter deal, where local stations get to run local commercials in return for running our show. So it's like they get free hosts that they don't have to pay money to. And then in return, we get to run our commercials on their air, and they get to run their commercials during our show. So the break has to be a certain length. They have to, you know, it has to
they
happen
have to know.
At certain times. Now, you can do what's called a floating break in the business, but we don't do that on Free Talk Live.
More chances for problems, too.
Although yeah. I do have to say it would be pretty sexy if the hosts here on the show would be able to watch the clock and figure that out and not have to have the outro music. That would
That's
be pretty
possible.
Nice.
That's something we could do. But you there know, are times just... where you'll get distracted in a conversation mm-hmm. and, you know, unless you have flashing lights going off in the studio to give you a heads up that...
Well, maybe
you,
we
you
could know, do that.
Well, that's a possibility. I don't have the engineering chops to set that up right now.
I'd like to have, you know, like a countdown clock that did the, you know, 30 seconds or whatever, and then just that way.
But the other music, the outro beds are not as obtrusive at all as they used to be. In fact, some people have complained that one of the complaints that's come out is that they're too quiet. Well, it doesn't matter whether you can hear it. All that matters is whether or not we know that it's
happening. This is intended to be the beige station wagon of music.
We're not here to play music for you on
this
show.
I will say this, though. The beds do, the quietness of the beds makes them sound... And this is my opinion, but it makes them sound a little less professional because they sound unbalanced. They don't sound balanced with the speaking volume of the show. So
they're not supposed to be. They're just supposed to be there to signal, you know,
but
to the
host. Being there should, I mean, there's a sort of a quality when you hear music on radio. And if it's so soft, it's like, this doesn't even sound right for a radio show.
You don't
want to
get drowned out, though, either.
No, but it should sound right for a radio show. It sounds unbalanced, is what I'm saying. It doesn't sound, you know, it sounds like, are they playing music in the background in the studio? What's going on here? It doesn't sound like it's where it's supposed to be at for a music bed coming in and out, you know?
Another part of this is that, you know, we hired a consultant, and among the best consultants in the country as far as radio goes, I would say he's the best. I've heard him speak for years, watched his videos online, think he's awesome. When you hire a consultant, then don't do what they say. I mean, who's the fool, right? There's lots of people that have opinions on this subject.
Well, we don't do everything the consultants say.
It's true, we don't. What we made the decision because he gave the suggestion. We thought it sounded good.
Yeah.
And like
he's not our boss.
Of the people involved, he's the most experienced. We're the second most experienced, and everybody else has their opinion. And I'm not saying they're fools and shouldn't have an opinion or anything like that. Your opinion is valid. It's your opinion. But I mean, the idea is to run a talk show, and the idea is to have the best talk show out there, and we think that this will make it better.
And there would have been nothing to make everyone happy, of course, as always, right?
If you're going to change the music, nobody's going
to
be
I remember years ago, Mark, you wanted me to play Frank Sinatra or something like that for intros, and you know, had I made that change, there would have been a bunch of butthurt people, and then there would have been somebody said, yeah, I love the Sinatra, guys, thanks.
Well, when I
in this case,
music...
we don't get anyone saying they love it, because there's nothing to love. There's nothing about these music beds that's, you know, really recognizable. Nobody's going to hear that and be like, oh yeah, I remember that tune from when I was a kid or whatever. There's nothing there like
that. It's
not
supposed
to be. Well, what if you drop the music beds entirely? Do you think there'd be people that would like that? I mean, there might have been.
I don't know. I don't know what the reaction would be. Yeah, we'd still have people complaining about that too if we dropped the beds entirely.
There would be, yes, but what I'm saying is that I do think it's a little conspicuous that there's not any kind of mix. You know, that there's not, and you know, some people saying, yeah, I like this, you know, like, and I feel
I don't think it's conspicuous at
all. I feel like if there were no music beds, that there might be some people to say, yeah, I like this.
I don't know.
Something to look at.
I might be wrong.
Yeah, I just, you know, I think having the music beds is important. Sometimes things go wrong, Johnson.
No,
so,
I agree with you. I'm
you know,
just saying.
For instance, like when you start a segment, if you're in the studio and you're not paying attention or something like that, then at least you've got the music bed that's running for a minute or whatever.
I absolutely agree with you on that. I just think that there's probably something subtle that may be off about how these music beds have been put into place, whether it's volume.
No, it's
whether
just
it's
the change.
I don't think that it is. I really
that's
don't.
That's all it is.
Again, I really don't think that is.
People bristle at change. I guarantee you that you know, next month we'll have as many radio stations as we've always had, if not more. Maybe we'll have, you know, the same level of podcast downloads.
I have no doubt about that.
If you're listening to Free Talk Live to hear music, you're listening for the wrong reasons, you know?
That's true.
And, you know, what else can we do? So there you go. Oh, and there's another one.
this is my favorite. I really love the way it rocks out. You hear that? The doot, doot, doot.
Is this your favorite one, Mark?
No, I have no preference. I think they're all boring.
You don't have a favorite?
Not really. Okay. I mean, I just heard them, and it's like, fine.
Okay. Well, anyway, we'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. We're not trying to excite you or bore you with the music beds. You shouldn't be listening to talk radio to hear the music. See you tomorrow. Free Talk Live.
Do you
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,217. Silver is trading around $17.34. And Bitcoin is trading around $353. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. In the news, an estimated crowd of 6,000 to 10,000 people will protest in Ferguson this weekend to mark the two-month anniversary of the death of Michael Brown. Hands Up United, Organization for Black Struggle, Missourians Organizing for Reform and Empowerment are all partnering together for a weekend of marches, panels, and planned civil disobedience. Liberty Beat reporter Derek Brose was assaulted and temporarily arrested while waiting to speak at a Houston City Council meeting on Tuesday. Brose had videotaped a Houston Police Department officer grabbing an activist representing Fluoride Free Houston, but then found himself in a similar situation.
I was accused of flipping off a council member and drug out of the council chambers into the hallway before being shoved around a bit more. Eventually, the officers realized I was not guilty of the victimless crime and decided to release me. I asked the officer for an apology, at which point he handcuffed me and accused me of using offensive, abusive language. Eventually, the commanding officers came out and released me with a citation.
Rose plans to contest the charges while raising awareness to the violations of First Amendment rights. Open source activists, scholars, researchers, and electronic freedom groups will celebrate Open Access Week from October 20th to the 26th by raising awareness about the need for free access to scholarly research. This year marks the 8th annual international event that aims to increase open access to information and research while informing the public about the dangers of costly access to knowledge. The theme for 2014 is Generation Open. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook, facebook.com, The Liberty Beat. Flu season is upon us, and the pressure to get the flu vaccine is high. But do you really need to get the shot to stay free of the flu this fall and winter? For the answer, we turn to Catherine Bleich.
The Liberty Beat caught up with Dr. Matthew Buckley to discuss the practical ways to fight off sickness without a flu shot.
So we know that the gut is approximately 80% of the immune system. If we're going to take care of our immune system, we have to stop polluting it with sugar, genetically modified food, unfiltered water, and processed carbohydrates. I recommend eating a Paleolithic diet.
The movement to resist vaccine pressure is growing as people begin to distrust the mainstream medical journals and Western allopathic medicine in general. Many individuals have discovered the power of their own body when it comes to fighting off illness. In addition to dietary changes, Dr. Buckley recommends supplementing with vitamin D.
Studies have shown that vitamin D is at least 3 times more effective than a flu vaccine when the levels are actually balanced out.
Ultimately, no one wants to get the flu. While some believe getting the shot will prevent this from happening, many studies show that building your own immune system may be your body's best defense against illness this flu season.
On Wednesday, the Houston City Council voted unanimously to ban the synthetic drug sometimes known as Kush. A state law was already passed in 2011. However, law enforcement have been unable to slow the spread of the drug because chemists make slight alterations to the chemical structure to avoid prosecution. The new law will fine store owners up to $2,000 per package if they continue to sell the synthetic drugs. This will require more funding for lab testing and undercover officers to enforce the ban. Houston Mayor Anise Parker stated the ban was necessary to stop users from experiencing permanent brain damage. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, October 9th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting.
From the day an ancient cave dweller painted yet another f***ing elk hunt on a wall in 15,000 BC, to Gary Marshall's 1974 discovery of 13 weather-beaten North Dakotan coal miners that would go on to become the cast of Happy Days, The Onion looks back at This Week in History. On June 17, 1954, the effects of the previous month's historic Supreme Court ruling in Brown versus the Board of Education provided black students with the educational opportunity of experiencing racism firsthand in desegregated schools. Up until that point, African American pupils could only endure racial slurs and death threats in city streets or near their homes. And on June 24, 1784, 13-year-old Edward Warren took the first hot air balloon flight, becoming the first American to urinate on a crowd from 100 feet in the air. And that was what happened this week in history.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.
All right, top of the hour to you. It is Off the Air Live, Thursday edition of the show. Today is Thursday, but really when you think about it, everything is now and nothing matters.